seconds.
This is Sholo Ford's presentation of high school football on iTalk 1067 FM and iTalk1067.com. Also brought to you in part by Northland Pioneer College, Ace Hardware of the White Mountains, Deemer's Glass, Beeler Orthodontics, Summit Regional Medical Center, Octopus Car Wash, Mountain Mobile Auto Glass, and Little Blue Bird Studios. And now, Sholo Ford presents high school football on iTalk 1067 FM and worldwide on iTalk1067.com.
Very good evening, and thank you for joining us here at Blue Ridge High School, where we have the number 3 Round Valley Elk, who are here to take on the number 6 Blue Ridge Yellow Jackets on a cold, clear, chilly night in November. Mike Granillo, it is a night for some championship football.
I mean, this is the way it is at 3A East. This is how you know that you're getting close to the playoffs, is because it's cold. And it's going to be a very exciting night. Going to be an interesting night, especially for the Elks, because they're kind of used to playing in the dome. It's been warm, and they're on our official turf. This is not. This field is going to get harder as the night goes on. And we'll see how that affects both teams here tonight. But as far as games across the state, Derek, this is it. All the other games, it's kind of like top team versus not a very good team. But this one means something tonight, so all eyes will be on it.
Now, of course, this is the last week of the regular season. And, of course, because 2020 puts everything on its ear, we had the first rendition of the power rankings that came out. That's how we referenced number 3 Round Valley and number 6 Blue Ridge, but that's not the only thing that's at stake here. A Blue Ridge win is going to force a three-way tie into in joining up Snowflake for the 3A East Championship. Yeah. Heaven only knows how they're going to try to break that down.
Well, they'll just call it a tie.
And I think that would be wise at this point.
But the thing is, the way they've set up the playoffs this year is that the top two teams from each region go to the playoffs, and then they take the next at-large teams or whatever. And so if these guys do have a three-way tie, all three are going to get into playoffs regardless. But it is going to make things interesting for the quote-unquote committee for this year.
Let's take a quick peek here at the Ace Hardware keys to the game. Ace Hardware has a 24/7 locksmith. The next time you're locked out of your car or just need a key replaced any hour of the day or night, any night of the week, call Ace Hardware, your helpful place with three locations in Pine Top, Overgard, and Sholo. As we start with the visiting Round Valley Elk, who are going to be reliant, you would think, an awful lot upon Seth Wiltbank, the junior running back who is coming off of a big day, not necessarily last week when they were just steamrolling Coronado, but against Snowflake, when we had him for more than 160 yards. We're very complimentary of his willingness to just take what the defense gave him. And as chilly as it is, you just talked about how reluctant Round Valley may be because of the circumstances with the weather to throw it out. Probably going to really need him to grind it out.
They are, and you know, he's a very patient runner. You know, that's the thing with Snowflake. We saw him against Snowflake, and he didn't get huge chunks at the beginning of the game, but as the game went on, his yards kept adding up and adding up until he finally was able to break some as those defenders fatigue a little bit as the night wears on.
Another player for the Elk who is able to get it done with his legs is the quarterback, and Owen Young, but he does have capable receivers that he is able to deliver the ball to. It's just a question is, how soft are the hands going to be in these chilly conditions, especially when they're used to playing in that dome?
You know, and it's always funny. Mike Colwell and I were just talking. You know, when you're younger, you come out here and you're like, I'm going to be tough. You know, and these receivers are probably going to be out there with no sleeves and no gloves. Man, they'll probably have gloves. And until they get that first hit or first ball, hard ball thrown at them, and then we'll see how tough they are. But they are. But Owen Young, I love his leadership for the Round Valley Elks. He is a great leader, and his will, I think, sometimes to get a yard or to get a half a yard or to make the play is infectious for his team, and so that's going to be a big key for him tonight.
Looking at the other side with the Yellow Jackets, P.J. London, the quarterback who is responsible for so many of the yards. He last week against Sholo had thrown for more than 100, also ran for more than 100. He is basically the central nervous system and every other vital organ of this offense. We'll take a quick peek also down the list, where Damon Mitchell is frequently his partner in crime. But the reason that they were able to have so much success last week is because Mitchell had such a great game on the ground. It feels as if between those two, how Blue Ridge's offense is going to go isn't necessarily going to be whether or not London is able to produce. You know he's going to, but how much is Mitchell going to be doing alongside him?
Well, that's a very important key that you talk about, because I think the ground game is going to be the difference in these in this game tonight. Who can control the line of scrimmage? Who can get the yards on the ground? Because that's going to spell the difference. And then, of course, probably the best thrower in the league, maybe in the state in 3A, is PJ London. He throws a great ball. His receivers are not always up on the same page with him, but we know he's going to get it done. So you're right, Damon Mitchell is going to be a huge key for tonight's game.
Now, last week against Sholo, he had many drops, and it was far more mild atmospherically than it was
right.
Tonight. So we'll have to keep an eye on that for both of the receivers. Receiving crews, as this is the Ace Hardware. Keys to the game, Ace Hardware has a 24/7 locksmith. The next time you're locked out of your car or just need a key replaced any hour of the day or night, any night of the week, call Ace Hardware. You have a place at three locations in Pine Top, Overgard, and Sholo. We got the number 3 Elk finishing the regular season at the number 6 Yellow Jackets. We will keep it going right after this. Sholo Ford's presentation of high school football on iTalk 106.7 and iTalk1067.com.
Who sells the number 1 truck in America? Sholo Ford. That's right. Not only do they sell it, Sholo Ford is the best place to buy it. Why? Guy Hatch guarantees it. In fact, he guarantees you'll get the best deal on your next Ford car, van, or SUV as well. It doesn't matter what you buy. Sholo Ford has the best deal. Sholo Ford on the east end of the Deuce and at SholoFord.com.
It's a tough game out there. We can help you reach your goals and come out victorious. Need help paying for college? Let the financial aid experts at Northland Pioneer College help you qualify for federal, institutional, or tribal grants. See our website at npc.edu for details. Northland Pioneer College, expanding minds, transforming lives.
I got this.
Don't take time out of your busy day. Let Mountain Mobile Auto Glass come to you. All our technicians are certified by the National Auto Glass Safety Council. Mountain Mobile Auto Glass will give you $50 cash, free movie passes, and free dinner.
536-5972. Mountain Mobile Auto Glass. Cash back to you.
Orthodontist Dr. Joshua Beeler has been providing family friendly orthodontics in Sholo and the entire White Mountains since 2006. If you need braces, stop in and see the friendly folks at Beeler Orthodontics and meet their professional staff. Dr. Beeler and his team have the latest in orthodontics technology, and they work with each patient individually to custom tailor the most effective treatment plan for the best results. Beeler Orthodontics is a proud sponsor of high school sports. Beeler Orthodontics, live to smile, love your smile.
Attention high school juniors and seniors. It's game time. Get ready to transform your life. Northland Pioneer College offers high school students the opportunity to earn college credit while in high school. Get ahead of the game. Complete college classes before you graduate. Visit npc.edu/advising to learn more. Northland Pioneer College, expanding minds, transforming lives.
You've been there, waiting forever at the gas station for the guy to free up so he can fill up your propane tank. Or worse, when the only qualified propane technician decided to stay home that day. Yep, you've been there and I have too. That's why now I get my propane from Ace Hardware every time. You get Ace Hardware's world-famous customer service when you stop in for propane. That's right, you get in, you get out, and you get a great deal on propane and everything else. From Ace Hardware at their locations in Pine Top and Heber. Ace Hardware is proud to support White Mountain Sports.
When you think glass, think Deemer's Glass in Lakeside. Deemer's Glass offers the best selection of quality glass with affordable prices. They do full home window packages, replacement windows, custom shower doors and enclosures, custom mirrors in many shapes, styles, and colors, glass doors and hardware, commercial glass for buildings and offices, skylights, screens, fire-rated glass for your fireplace or stove, window film, and more. Visit Deemer's Glass today on Porter Mountain Road in Lakeside or call 1-888-GLASSMAN.
Winning takes focus, preparation, and support. Keep focused on your dream career while saving thousands in tuition costs at Northland Pioneer College. We're here to support your goals and see you succeed. Visit npc.edu to see our programs. An academic advisor will get you on the right path to achieve your educational goals. Northland Pioneer College, expanding minds, transforming lives.
Summit Healthcare Regional Medical Center is a proud supporter of high school sports. Many of our local sports players were born at the hospital, where Summit Obstetrics offers comfortable individual rooms for mom and baby. In case of a sports injury, the hospital ER is always staffed and prepared to take on the most serious injuries, and Summit features an advanced diagnostics department with state-of-the-art equipment. The Summit Healthcare Orthopedic and Therapy teams can help sports players overcome injuries and return to the game. Summit Healthcare Regional Medical Center wishes all players a successful and healthy season this year.
Getting ready to get it started here at Blue Ridge High School. It's the regular season finale, the number three Round Valley Elk, finishing the season in the weather here away from the dome against these number six Yellow Jackets as P.J. London is ready to walk to midfield, where he will be met by Riley Hamblin, the two captains for these two squads. Of course, the Yellow Jackets wearing yellow helmets, purple tops, purple pants, Round Valley with black hats, and then white tops and white pants. As we
head, that's the tail you're going to call it. You're going to call it in the air where Mr. Sneed can hear you. I'm going to flip it. If I don't catch it, the first time we will reflip.
Tails.
It is a tail you get to choose. Okay, Round Valley wins the toss. They'll defer. You want the football. Which way would you like to kick it? Okay, put your back there with Mr. Sneed. You're with me. Blue Ridge will receive. All right, gentlemen, come out. Let's have a good fight.
You heard it. Round Valley wins the toss, elects to defer. Blue Ridge will receive.
Captain Riley Hamblin.
On a chilly night, where according to thermometer phone, it is 45 degrees at kickoff.
Oh, balmy.
Balmy indeed. It could be 40.
Yeah, it will be.
They opted to kick off.
There we go. That's the spirit.
Blue Ridge will receive.
As the Summit Healthcare Regional Medical Center injury report, Summit Regional Medical Center has everything your athlete needs to get back in the game. I don't believe there are any injuries to speak, or are there?
We had a couple of possibilities. Herschel Gregg, one of the linebackers for the Blue Ridge Yellow Jackets. We're not sure if he is actually okay. And then Ronan Palmer, one of the linemen for Blue Ridge, were both out last week. We'll see if they suit
Palmer
up.
Palmer was dressed when they did the senior day.
Yeah. Christian Roman.
Okay.
Sorry.
That I can't speak of one. With any authority. But we'll keep an eye out here on the sideline, as that is the Summit Healthcare Regional Medical Center injury report. Summit Regional Medical Center has everything your athlete needs to get back in the game. As the Yellow Jackets just now coming out of their end zone and ready to man the sideline, Round Valley is already primed and ready to go as getting ready to kick this away for the Elk is...
Isn't it Garcia? Armando Garcia?
I believe it is.
Yeah, the sophomore.
Armando
should be. He was a little inconsistent last time we saw him.
He's got a good leg indoors. Let's see. I think this will give us a good idea about how everybody's appendage is going
to
be feeling.
And I don't know. Well, it'll be interesting to see that Round Valley chose to go with the wind the first quarter. We'll see. But they don't have the ball.
Back to receive here for the Yellow Jackets is Jacob Curran. There's a pretty good boot taken into Curran right at the six-yard line. He waits for his blockers to get set up along the near hash. Now starts making a couple bad passes. He gets into the open field at the 40. He's at midfield now in the open foot races. He's trying to get to the sideline on the far side of the field, but he's going to be tracked down by Hamblin, but a great return without any flags.
Well, and that was a touchdown-saving tackle by Riley Hamblin. But, boy, you could see the great development of the Blue Ridge back wedge picking up all the key blocks there. And then Kern shows great patience and finds the hole and just sprints through it. And, boy, what a start for the Blue Ridge Yellow Jackets. First punch could mean a big difference here for tonight's game. And Blue Ridge has great field position.
We talked about before we got on the air, these are two excellently coached football teams. As London now getting ready to go under center, he's got Mitchell behind him, but now some motion. Marbello now is going to stand on London's right as Mitchell comes into the slot, but there's high snap is going to go all the way back to the 45. London picks it up, but now he's being pursued by many an Elk as Owen Young is the first one there and stopping him on the Blue Ridge 49. London picks it up, but now he's being pursued by many an Elk as Owen Young is the first one there.
Wow, and all that great positive momentum that the Jackets just had, they just just gave it up there with us. I mean, London's not short. He goes about 6'2", and that was well over his head. He had no chance to get that. I'm a little surprised that he tried to pick that up with the cold weather, but he wanted to try to make something happen, just could not get away from the pursuit of the Elks.
This is the first truly chilly night of this young, weird season, and I think there is our first indication about how the weather is going to be a factor. Is it's now 2nd and 35. Got Kern and Esparza going out wide to the left. Mitchell's in the slot on the left side. Is they're going to move the pocket in that direction. Now London holds up. Now he's pressuring, trying to spin away.
Boy.
He's all the way back to the 30 of his own territory, looking for a block. Now as he throws it over the middle where it's tipped
intercepted.
Picked up by Hamblin, who's making a man miss to get to the 40. He's over midfield. Now he's at the far sideline. London is the only man he's got to try to get by as he pushes him out of bounds at the 10. There's a flag back at the Round Valley 46. Oh, no, that's a 40, 44. And this is probably going to be a blocking infraction, I would imagine.
Well, we'll see. I tell you, London, unlucky on that one. Went off of his receiver's hands. It might have been tipped by a Round Valley defender.
It was.
But, yeah, just Hamblin then just happens to be in the right place at the right time. But credit, you know, that's the one thing about this Round Valley team that I don't think people really appreciate is the
speed. Got a block
speed.
In the back, Round Valley. First and 10, Round Valley.
So they do get the interception, but, man, what a quick turn of events after the big kick return by the Yellow Jackets. They just went way negative in a big hurry.
There, got to point out that Cisco was one of the Elk who was in hot pursuit. We called his name an awful lot when the Elk were hosting Snowflake, as that was uncharacteristic play from the Yellow Jackets. Now let's see if the Round Valley offense is able to find its footing a little bit more rapidly as Hamblin and Ortiz are coming out wide to the left side. Owen Young from the shotgun. He's got Wiltbank off on his left as the shotgun snap is had, and they hand it off to Wiltbank. Kick it out to the near side, looking for some blockers, and there's a big block in the back, but I don't see a flag.
No flag, huh? Wow.
And that'll be a Mountain Mobile Autoglass first down.
Wow, we had that was right in front of us. We had a great view of that one, and but nonetheless, great block down by the Elks line, and Wiltbank does the rest, running off the backside of his tackle, and just showing again great speed and patience, trying to let blocks develop in front of him. Jackets have got to try to do a better job of getting to the point of attack and not let Wiltbank get a full head of steam.
Just 9 yards on that one. I prematurely called it a first down. 10 minutes to go. Here's Round Valley's first offensive possession after the London interception. Young from the shotgun again with Wiltbank on his left. This time Young's going to keep it. Now pitch it out on the near sideline to Wiltbank, who has enough for a first down. Only needed 1 yard. They gained three or four as Roman is there with the stop.
You know, Round Valley has been known for their execution. That was not a well-executed play as Owens kind of crowded Wiltbank quite a bit, and that was very dangerous. When you try to pitch that close together, bad things can happen in a hurry. The Elks lucky there that they didn't put that one on the ground.
Move it out to their own 43-yard line. 9 minutes and 40 seconds left after that was the Mountain Mobile Autoglass first down. There's no score. Round Valley picked off London's first pass, ran it back to the 10, but a blocking infraction sent it back into their own territory. Now Tripp's going out wide to the right. Lone man on the near side. Instead, it's going to be handoff to Wiltbank, who bounces off one tackler. He approaches midfield where he's gang tackled. P.J. London was the first man there, but a good gainer there for Wiltbank. Pick up five.
Well, Wiltbank was hit at the line of scrimmage, but he does a great job of running through the tackle. He kept those legs moving and didn't allow the defender, as you could see there, to really get a good wrap-up, and that allowed him to get through and break free. He's running hard right off the gate. Right now, intensity-wise, sure seems like Round Valley playing with a lot more intensity than the Yellow Jackets on senior night.
Also going very deliberately here in the chilly weather as they go with the same formation. Funaki, the lone man, wide to the left as they got Trips going up to the far side, but Hamblin coming in motion as they fake the handoff. Again, pitch this one out to Wiltbank, who's trying to let his blocker set up. Now cuts it back up, gets over midfield, gets down to the 45, picks up seven, and has another Mountain Mobile Autoglass first down.
Boy, talk about making something out of nothing. Just a great job there by Wiltbank as Owen was hit in the backfield. Jackets did a good job there. I actually think Wiltbank might have thrown that one forward, but didn't matter because he was behind the line of scrimmage. So credit Wiltbank again, just showing great vision and, as you said, waited for his blockers. Again, Jackets had to get a few more guys to him because he's been they've been unable to bring him down by one man.
8:20 to go here in the first. Again, going 3-by-1 from the shotgun. Young hands this off to Wilt Bank. Cuts this up the center as he gets toward the 40. Picks up 4 on the first down carry. Marbello, the first player there.
Well, hopefully Wilt Bank has been doing some extra conditioning this week because it sure looks like they're going to have a steady diet of Wilt Bank, of Seth Wilt Bank. The Jackets seem to be settling down maybe just a little bit, getting to that point of attack. But here's the thing is that all the focus is going to be on Wilt Bank right now. This might be a great time for Owens to ride him and take it on the option.
Haven't looked the throw yet, have the Elk, and we've seen the first adjustment playing outdoors in the cold with a lot of option play on the first drive. As he's got Wilt Bank on his left, Young from the shotgun, drops back, starts
on
moving
cue.
In this direction, looks along the near sideline where he's trying to find Ortiz. He's got a little bit of separation, but it goes right between his hands and incomplete. Mitchell was there defending pretty well, but I think that most quarterbacks who are watching that one would feel as if that one should have been brought in.
Should have definitely been caught. I mean, Mitchell was there but late, and that just went right through the hands of Ortiz. And he's been a very reliable receiver, just could not come down with that one. And that should not be a dome versus outdoor factor. That ball was well thrown. The wind is really not a factor right now. So the Elks might look back on that one and think that was definitely an opportunity missed.
Clock stopped at 7:30 to play here in the first quarter. Round Valley facing its first third down play. 3rd and 6 is there. A low snap, but it's going to be brought in. Hand this one off to Hamblin, who's going over the 40, has the first down, and then cut down at the 25 after he has a couple more yards after contact.
And
Franco Harris, the first one, that was actually Kyron Clark.
Yeah, Kyron Clark on the reception there. But great job. The Elk do a great job. That's just a great scheme right there. They get all the receivers running down the field to clear out the zone, and then they bring Clark in underneath, and he's really wide open. Linebackers late getting out there. Owen Young does a great job of finding him.
No score, but Round Valley approaching the red zone. Again going 3-by-1. Funaki, the lone man on the near side, is Young from the shotgun. Moves the pocket to the right, now stops, going to the far sideline where he's got a man open, but it's deflected by London.
No, I don't think it was London. London's over here in the middle of
the
play.
That was Mitchell.
Damon Mitchell was hoping he was as tall as P.J. London right there. And the thing is, he stopped early, it seemed like. Damon Mitchell did. He could have kept going back with the receiver, and it would have been an easier interception. Instead, he stopped short, tried to get it at the high point. It was just higher than he anticipated. But, boy, Round Valley has thrown 3 times, and 2 of those have not turned out the way they wanted.
That stops the clock at 6:57 to go. No score still as 3 receivers bunch up on the right of the line. This time Young hands off Wilt Bank, forced to bounce it outside.
And
now accelerates. He gets to the 20, using a blocker upfield. He gets to the 15, has a Mountain Mobile Autoglass first down. Hamblin, though, is the one that was really able to get the surge to allow him to get that first down.
Boy, again, just great patience. Really nothing doing at the beginning, but he just kept stretching it to the outside and then used a burst of speed to get upfield and to get into that secondary where he was able to pick up those big yards. And, boy, a methodical march. I'm surprised Round Valley has tried to go with the big play through the air because the methodical march, Blue Ridge has not had an answer for the ground game so far.
Wilt Bank with 40 yards on 6 carries as he's now on Owen Young's right. Same formation with Hamblin, the lone man on the near side. Young calls his own number out of the option, runs up the right of the line, and is spun down after a positive gain of 3.
Boy, Marbello had a big shot opportunity there in the backfield, but just could not come up with it. And good job faking, Young does, but really nothing doing for him. But you got to keep the defense honest. So now the defense, you know, they've probably been keying on Wilt Bank. So Young decides to keep it.
Put this on the Blue Ridge 12. This drive started with a Riley Hamblin interception. He is in there now, split wide left. There's a new running back out there for Round Valley. The thrown away from it is it's going to be brought in by Clark again. He gets to the far sideline, tries to force his way into the end zone.
He
does so
it.
For the score. Touchdown, Round Valley. 12 yards out.
12-yard completion. Wow. The short pass really nicely done by Owen Young, and they catch Clark. Obviously, the Round Valley coaching staff saw something in film that they thought they could really use Clark to be as basically a tight end, coming across, dragging across, because they've done it twice, and Clark has been able to get big gains on both of them. What? Oh, they're saying no touchdown.
So the initial signal from the official on – okay, he put his hands up, and I thought that he signaled, right. No, it was a touchdown. remaining out there.
Garcia just wants to kick it.
Is Armando Garcia, who's going from that far hash as his team leads 6-0. High snap is down. The kick is away and not good. So let's see how that plays later on in the ball game. 5:46, a long drive punctuates the Hamblin interception to give the Elk a 6-0 lead here on finale weekend. It's Sholo Ford's presentation of high school football on iTalk 106.7 and iTalk1067.com.
Who sells the number one truck in America? Sholo Ford. That's right. Not only do they sell it, Sholo Ford is the best place to buy it. Why? Guy Hatch guarantees it. In fact, he guarantees you'll get the best deal on your next Ford car, van, or SUV as well. It doesn't matter what you buy. Sholo Ford has the best deal. Sholo Ford on the east end of the Deuce and at SholoFord.com.
Second seizure audio, guys.
Right there.
While you're on the road, you're trying to get all sorts of momentum going into playoffs. You're also trying to secure a 3A East championship, your first rear back in the 3A East in about 10 of them. So what do? You pick off a pass and you go about 6 minutes to get into the end zone. You talked about how much more energetic Round Valley seemed. And the Yellow Jackets are now going to have to try to match that. And I think that the big way to do that might be going away from what your instincts would tell you and just try to get P.J. Leonard involved. I think they've really got to get Mitchell going.
Yeah. And, well, for sure they got to be going forward. They had the big kickoff return, but they went backwards on their next two plays.
So Northland Pioneer College kickoff. It's time for North. When it comes time for your college, kick off your college education, choose the college with the lowest tuition in the state of Arizona, only $40 an hour, as they kick it again to Kern, who's this time going to run right up into his wedge and get brought down at the 25.
Well, interesting. You know, you mentioned, I don't know how long it's been since Round Valley has been in the 3A East. It's been I think it's been more than 10 years. It's been a very, probably since Seymour. You think just 10? Could be just 10. But, yeah, a long time. But they weren't this – this was a better team. Seymour had his sons who were very good, but – oh, yeah. But this team is executing on all cylinders.
So now looking to answer, having just run two plays offensively, London's going to go under center, split backs behind him. Everybody bunched up around the line of scrimmage as Kern goes in motion right to left. Now sets up in the slot on the far side as the handoff goes. Marbello tries to get some surge going to left side.
There's
nothing doing there, but a flag comes out as he's brought down. This may be a face mask, but we will wait for the official notice.
Yeah, it was a long look, but I'm not sure he did get the face mask. He might have got a horse, you know, the collar. Oh, they're going to say face mask. I think that's a bad call. The line judge here, the farthest away from it, saw it, but you can see he got inside the shoulder pad, but that's a benefit for the Jackets.
Well, 15 yards either way, right?
You know, I don't know what the call is on the front of the – he had him on the front of the shoulder pad. So it's not – he didn't have him on the back like a horse collar, so – interesting call.
It certainly isn't what Coach Bell wants to see with his team riding so much momentum. Is there a similar formation? Now they start shifting. Mitchell is going to go into the slot as well as two other players off the left of the line. London starts running in that direction. He's got some space. Now as he gets over midfield, and he's pushed out of bounds after picking up another Mountain Mobile Auto Glass first down.
Well, and P.J. London, we know he's got speed, but he also has the size. So you got to make sure you don't lower your head if you go over to tackle him. But a great block there, initial block by Damon Ethan Marbello, who came up and picked off the outside linebacker or defensive end. I'm not sure which one, but did a great job to spring London there. And so the Jackets finally have some positive momentum going.
10 yards on that carry. 5 minutes and 8 seconds left here in the first quarter. 6-0 Round Valley leading. As a man comes in motion, this time left to right is again Kern, is from the shotgun. London takes the snap, but a false start. I think Kern started turning upfield.
I think that's a Sparza.
False snap, false start, blurred.
Oh, that is Esparza. You're correct.
But I didn't. You thought he went upfield a little early?
I did.
Yeah, that's a tough one for high school. You know, I've not seen Blue Ridge do a lot of this shifting and moving guys around, but they obviously saw something on film that they're trying to expose on the Round Valley defense. But sometimes it gets you in trouble if you're not used to it.
Now Curran is split wide outside. He's matched up with Ortiz. As Esparza again comes in motion. Now they're going to try to drop it off to him in the flat. A low pass is going to hit the deck first and go incomplete.
Oh. Looked like he got under it, but we don't have a very good vantage point on that type of pass there. But so far, Jackets again still don't look real crisp. That was an easy pass. Should have been an easy pass and catch for the Yellow Jackets, but London just put a little too much down, nose down, and that's where it ended up, in the turf. They're playing
hot. Second down and 15. They got 15 yards because of the face mask, and now trying to work with it. Now working with an offset backfield with Mitchell behind London, who's going to drop back deep. Now he's pressured, goes up in the pocket, pressured, wrapped up, and brought down. Clark is there. Keanu Clark is going to be there with the stop and a loss back into Blue Ridge territory, all the way back to the 41.
And that's what we call a coverage sack, because Blue Ridge even kept max protection, and the reason they had the two backs in the backfield was to help pick up oncoming rushers. They did that, but they could not hold back Clark the whole time.
Same formation, third and 20. Mitchell is back in the pistol, is now again dropping back, trying to set up a screen, get this one up to Mitchell, who's going to have to make one man miss and can't do so as he tries to get to the far sideline. Marble is there with the stop, and a 6-yard gain when you needed 20 is not going to do it.
Well, great job out there. I think Morgan Arona out there as well. Arona, yeah, and he,
Arona.
You know, and he's that little small undersized offensive linebacker though that's just everywhere. And as you mentioned, Derek, that was just a great open field tackle, and that was the difference. Otherwise, Mitchell probably has a lot of room to run.
Back to receive Hamblin. Waiting for London's kick, another high snap, but he's able to get underneath that one
and
kind of run into it.
One.
And Hamblin telling everybody to stay away, takes a Blue Ridge bounce, starts angling toward the sideline, and is kicked out of bounds near the 5. Woo! Gunnar Martinez there on the special teams play to force that out of bounds. Round Valley, who just ground out a long drive, is going to have to do so now with 96 yards separating the Elk from pay dirt. And P.J. London, who already had one snap go over his head as a quarterback, that time really had to elevate to try to prevent a real disaster. And he was able to make an awful lot out of it.
And we've seen Round Valley in special teams. They focus on that as well. They do a great job coming after the punter. We saw him get Snowflake. And almost had, the high snap doesn't help.
3:38 to go here in the first quarter as the Elk take over, leading 6-0. They're on their own 7. Wilt Bank is standing on Young's left. They fake the handoff now as Young's going to come back to the left, looking for some blockers upfield, but this time I think they saw the hold. London there with the stop, but a flag came out late.
Yeah, I think Round Valley has gotten away with a few, but they are not. I'll wait for the call. Yep. They have not been calling it a whole lot. They've been trying to let the guys play, but they just, especially
holding
when those runs.
Round Valley, 6-0, half the distance goal, repeat first down.
Especially when those runs go to the outside. Young started kind of up in the middle and then tried to bounce the outside, and that's just a kiss of death for an outside blocker because your defender starts inside and then works outside on you. But I don't be surprised if Round Valley doesn't try to throw a pass right here. They still have the wind at their back, and they might catch Blue Ridge sleeping.
Just moves him back to the 4. I believe Wiltbank just came out. Oh, he is in there. So he's standing on Young's left, and they fake the handoff coming to the near sideline where it's nearly brought in by Hamblin, but well defended was Kern.
Yeah, and obviously not Blue Ridge was not necessarily asleep. But Round Valley was on the same page as I was, but Kern all over that, really had a chance to intercept that, but he slowed down. If he would have kept running, he might have had a chance at that one.
Second down now and 14. Deep in their own territory.
And now Round Valley might be in a position where they might feel like they have to pass on second and long.
Wiltbank standing alongside Young on the goal line as this time they do give it to him. He starts running to the right, trying to get to the edge, but now cuts it up.
Great.
He's got a little bit of space. Says he was quickly, though, had that evaporate as Mitchell was able to get there, but that moves them well away from the end zone, and that's a pretty big pickup there on second down.
Ethan Marbello tried to get to the outside, and he just overran it. You know, the pursuit angle wasn't there, and Wiltbank just does a great job of putting on the brakes and cutting up inside. Now, luckily for the Jackets, they had some pursuit that time and were able to bring them down, but it does bring up a third and manageable now for Round Valley. And we'll see if they might have to burn a timeout here.
Well, a lot of confusion with the personnel, but they now break huddle. Nobody's counting yet.
There it is.
They will take a timeout. Round Valley uses its first timeout on third and eight with 2 minutes and 37 seconds left in the first quarter. 6-0 they lead. It's Sholo Ford's presentation of high school football on iTalk 106.7 and iTalk1067.com.
It's a tough game out there. We can help you reach your goals and come out victorious. Need help paying for college? Let the financial aid experts at Northland Pioneer College help you qualify for federal, institutional, or tribal grants. See our website at npc.edu for details. Northland Pioneer College. Expanding minds, transforming lives.
Round Valley uses its first timeout, facing third, and they're calling it eight, but it looks like it's closer to seven.
Six even.
Wiltbank, who has 47 yards on seven carries, standing alongside his quarterback, who's working from the shotgun. Low snap. They're going to throw it, try to get a screen set up. It was read well by Kern, but Wiltbank, who is not able to make anybody miss after he stepped around Kern. Herschel was there.
Yeah, great read by Kern. You know, and that's the one thing that offenses, they forget about. Yeah, you take a timeout because it's a big third down, but you also give the defense the opportunity to talk to your defenders about, hey, look for this play because they like to run this on third and short.
Got 3 yards on that carry. Is there punt's going to hang up for Wallace, and he'll take it just in Blue Ridge territory. It was well covered, but he's able to get away from that first tackler, but not the next two.
Yeah, just good downfield pursuit by the Elks. Good, nice high punt by the punter there, but Blue Ridge will take it as they get to start in Elk territory. And we saw Blue Ridge at least be able to move the ball a little bit. Now we'll see with a short field and the first quarter winding down whether they can try to get this thing knotted up.
Yellow Jackets have one play for real positive yardage. That was a P.J. London run for 10 yards. Otherwise, they've been having a hard time getting out of their way right after they picked up that first down, was going in the wrong direction because of a false start. And now going to set up, at least initially, with London going under center, but now some movement behind the line as Esparza moves from the left to the right, but they're going to turn handoff to Mitchell. Steps away from one tackler at the line of scrimmage, but then is gang tackled after he picks up a yard.
Well, and I tell you what, the defensive line for the Round Valley Elks, they just blew up the blocking scheme. Blue Ridge was trying to pull a man in order to create a trap on the inside, but he just got blown into the backfield. I believe that was Andy Hoffmeyer that just couldn't get to his block, and that left Mitchell hanging out to dry.
Push London back into the shotgun. I believe that is Marbello in the pistol. As Esparza moves in motion left to right, drop back, trying to get it to Esparza. This time he's able to get this one, but it was a pass that hung up a little bit and allowed the Elk to swarm. And just another short gain of maybe a yard.
Boy, I tell you, the Elks are just flying around right now. They're just great pursuit to the ball, and it's not just one man. Because you saw Esparza, he kind of made the first guy miss, but he slowed him down enough that the rest of the next four Round Valley defenders were there to finish him off.
Third down and eight. Less than a minute to go here in the first quarter. Three receivers off to the left as Marbello, the lone man in the backfield, dropping back, trying to go over the flat, but overshooting his receivers as it falls incomplete, and there are no flags down there as PJ's a little bit frustrated with himself.
Well, yeah, he missed that one. Esparza did come open. I think the problem was PJ had to get rid of it a little earlier than he wanted. The Jackets had a tight end there, and they kept him in for blocking purposes, but it could not slow down the rush of the Elks, and London had to get rid of it just a bit earlier, and Esparza was not quite ready.
Back to receive is Hamblin. London, who brought in a very high snap on the last punting effort, this time has it hit him in the numbers, sets it up there as he kicks a high hanger that Hamblin is again going to allow to bounce, and this one starts angling away from Hamblin a little bit sooner, but will still take a good Yellow Jacket roll down to the 10.
You know, Derek, I feel like the Jackets need to just try to keep trying to pursue the ground game and run some options. We know P.J. London is a capable runner, and make them honor him, but run some options. Run some dives with Marbello, but let PJ London ride him and maybe possibly pull it and try to get to the outside.
Another long field for Round Valley. They lead 6-0 to the Elk. 34 seconds left here in the first quarter, as this is the third possession after they opted to defer to the second half.
Well, and I would expect a steady diet of Wilt Bank after that last possession.
He's standing on Young's right as they fake the handoff. Young now trying to go to the far sideline where it's nearly intercepted twice. Cody Wallace was initially, no, he was the one diving at it. I think Mitchell was the first crack.
And I think
reverse that.
And I think Dimitri Muncy got into the backfield and hit Young as he was going to throw that. That elevated the ball just a little bit, and I think allowed who do we decide was there first? Wallace was there first to deflect that, so allowed him to get there. But yeah, and then it was tipped up the air, and all kinds of craziness ensued.
Again, 3-on-1. Man on the near side is Rivera. As from the shotgun, Young fakes the handoff. Again, looking to his right. Now he's going to tuck it. He's got a little bit of space, but he's brought down from
ball
behind.
Loose? No.
Gonzalez there with the stop after Young picks up two, and that should probably be the last play of this first quarter.
When I said I thought Round Valley would go to a steady diet of Wilt Bank, I meant that they should go with a steady diet of Wilt Bank. The deep pass has not seemed to be there for the Elks so far tonight, but Wilt Bank has pretty much had his way. I don't know why they've gone away from that.
That will be the way the first quarter ends. Round Valley uses an interception and a long drive to get on the scoreboard first and lead 6-0 after one. It's Sheldon Ford's presentation of high school football on iTalk 106.7 and iTalk1067.com.
I got this.
Don't take time out of your busy day. Let Mountain Mobile Auto Glass come to you. All our technicians are certified by the National Auto Glass Safety Council. Mountain Mobile Auto Glass will give you $50 cash, free movie passes, and free dinner.
536-5972 Mountain Mobile Auto Glass. Cash back to you.
Get ready to start the second quarter. The number 3 Round Valley Elk leading the number 6 Blue Ridge Yellow Jackets 6-0. And we'll be facing a third down, we'll call it 8. So a little bit of a surprise to you, Mike, that Round Valley's tried to air it out here again deep in its own territory.
You know, they're trying to go play action, but they haven't given the ball Wilt Bank in a while, so the play action doesn't really do any good until you give them the ball a few times. You know, if they would have gone play action, I mean, given the ball on first down and second down, then a play action on third down, they might be able to hit something big.
Got the pass-catching tight end in Kyron Clark, who's going to come out with Wilt Bank, split wide to the right side. 5 receivers set. Ortiz is going out furthest to the left. As Young, who can run it, is going to set this in motion. Fake and give to Rivera. Ball fake. Now he's pressured. He's trying to find some room to run with, but he is going to be cut down after a short gain of just 1.
Well, the Elks were trying to run a little bubble screen to the outside, but the Jackets were all over it. But wisely, Owen Young, deep in his own territory, decides not to throw it, but takes it. And the Jackets got pressure with only 3 that time. That's something they might look to try to continue to do.
Finaki is going to punt this with his heel on his goal line as he gets the snap and puts this one up. It's short. Running into it is Wallace, but now allows it to bounce and takes a Round Valley hop back into Blue Ridge territory. But right now, if absolutely nothing else, Blue Ridge winning the field position battle, and that could be something that could come into play here because Mitchell's been known to pop one.
That's the only thing they're winning right now, though. We talked at the beginning of the broadcast, you know, the trenches, who's going to control the line of scrimmage? Well, Round Valley has done that, which is why I'm surprised they haven't run the ball more on their last several possessions. But even on the defensive side, Blue Ridge not able to get anything going on the ground game because Round Valley's with their front 4 are blowing up the offensive linemen.
Starting on their own 48, 11:22 to go in the half, trailing 6-0. Send Kern out wide to the right. London goes under center. Turn and give to Mitchell. This time he's got a little bit of space as he cuts it over to the left side and gets down to the 46-yard line, picks up 5 before Rivera stops him, but there's a big gain on first down.
Well, we'll see if the Jackets don't just do a whole lot of that here on this drive because that quick hitting play, there wasn't any misdirection or anything. Just go man on man. Let's give it to our senior running back and see what he can do.
Second down and 4. That was Mitchell's first carry. as London again going under center. Now some movement.
Oh, see, here we go.
And Franco Harris is behind him with Mitchell also in the backfield. Hand off to Harris, who's he's going straight up the gut. Gets over the 35. He's still on his feet as he gets down to the 20. Still on his feet as he gets finally brought down at the 18. Mount Mobile's first down in a gain of 20.
Franco Harris, he put on about 25, 30 pounds over the summer, did the young sophomore, and he's a hard-nosed player, just a tough kid. And I kind of had a feeling when they brought him in, he was in for that one reason, and they were going to run the option. But P.J. London saw the give, and he wisely gave it.
Actually, a gain of 30 on that Mount Mobile Auto Glass first down, and there's that field position.
They're going to do the same thing to this side.
As there, it's handed off to, again, Harris, but this time he's going to be brought down after a shorter gain, but still pretty good one of 6. Make it 7 all the way down to the 10.
Young on the tackle there coming up from the safety, but Blue Ridge just going back, as I mentioned, at the end of their last possession, just good old veer options. And P.J. London so far running it very well. We'll see if they do it again.
Got the same formation, but now go to the offset eye. Mitchell deep. They turn and give it to him. He starts trying to get to the right side, but Clark is there stopping him in the backfield. Great penetration there by Kyron Clark.
Kyron Clark is so fast off the end, and you have to account for him. Blue Ridge probably was thinking, well, we don't have to block the end there because we're running away from him, but he's so fast down the line that he's still able to blow that play up. And there was a little bit of confusion, and I think that slowed down Mitchell enough to get Clark there for the tackle.
Third down and 4. I formation again behind. Well, now they're off to the left a little bit, but now the movement will have them split back behind London. Turn and give to Harris, who runs into all sorts of bodies at the line of scrimmage. Clark was there first. He did force his way forward to gain a couple of yards on this cold night. Temperature now reading at 43 degrees. London's a capable field goal kicker. Do you go for it on 4th and 2?
I have to go for it right now if I'm Blue Ridge. I'm the underdog. This is the best field. This is the best momentum we've had. I'm going to ride this for all I can, and we're going to try to go for it. Now, Blue Ridge may have to call a timeout in order to do it, but watch for London to keep on this one.
Everybody bunched up along there, and he fumbles the football, and it looks as if it's not going to matter. It's 4th down, so coming out of the scrum is Finaki, and Round Valley forces, well, I don't know, can we call that a fumble recovery? Is that just a turnover on downs? Bad snap. I mean, as soon as he couldn't handle the snap, it didn't matter what happened.
Right, but it's still, I mean, it's still a fumble and a recovery, but wow. Just shooting yourself in the foot is, I mean, I know that's the cliche to use, but it almost doesn't do justice what's happening right now to the Blue Ridge Yellow Jackets there. But they're doing it to themselves. There's no one else to blame.
8:41 to play in the half. Round Valley gave up the 30-yard run, but no points. And I think they had too many men in the huddle.
Legal substitution.
These are two very, very, very well-coached teams.
Legal substitution, Round Valley.
We saw Round Valley play Snowflake 2 weeks ago. We saw Blue Ridge play Sholo. And I think there's been more flags in these, but I mean, just in this first half combined as there were in the last two ball games.
It's a big game. Uh-oh.
Oh, there's Wiltbank going to the left side. Another flag comes out, so this is probably all moot, but he has a run out to the 35. It would be a 30-yard gain, but hold the phone. Holding is called against the Elk.
Well, you know, the funny thing is it sure looked like we didn't get a replay at the beginning of the play, but, boy, it sure like Wiltbank was dead to rights. Now, we know he's a patient runner, as there we maybe see it, but, sure enough, 54 was being held. That was Dimitri Muncy was being held.
77. Half distance of goal. Repeat one.
I think that was great gamesmanship there by Muncy, because I think he was initially doing the holding, and then he...
But you're allowed to as a defender.
Grabbed a hold and to try to sell it.
Yeah, it was out in the open, unfortunately, for Clark. But a huge break for the Blue Ridge Yellow Jackets as Wiltbank, again, showing that patience, letting the holes develop, and then hits it with great speed.
First and 15, back to the 2. And the shotgun snap is going to be kept by Young. Comes to the right side. Now tries to go back toward the middle of the field where he has a big gain on first and 15. PJ is there with the tackle, but not before about 12 yards picked up there by Young.
Well, PJ London may be having his struggles on the offensive side, but he's played great on the defensive side so far. He's come up and made big tackles on the run game. He's been, where he's supposed to be in the passing attack. Now, on second and short. I mean, we're calling this short. It's 5 or 6 yards, but this might be a time where a play action for Round Valley might prove effective.
Everybody's bunched up again along the line of scrimmage as Wilbank is on Young's left. He gets the call, starts running in this direction as he cuts it up again, gets to the 20. He's still on his feet as he's over the 20, brought down by Mitchell, but not before he picks up 8 yards and has a Mountain Mobile Auto Glass first down.
Blue Ridge has got to do a better job of getting off of blocks and getting scraping to the outside, because Kern did a great job of turning Wilbank back to the inside just like he's supposed to, but there was nobody there for Blue Ridge to finish him off. Kern was out there on an island, and no help, no pursuit, and that allows Wilbank to pick up those big yards.
7 minutes and 40 seconds. Now, there hasn't been a lot of offense outside of that 30-yard run by Franco Harris since Round Valley was able to grind out that six-minute drive, but this one's starting to take that complexion as Young from the shotgun again with Wilbank on the left, fakes the handoff, he's going to keep, goes to the left, uses the block to get it over the 25, still on his feet at the 30, and tackled forward to the 31.
Again, Blue Ridge just kind of seems to be hesitant. They're trying to figure things out on the fly, and you cannot figure things out on the fly. You've got to go where your read tells you to go, and that's it. And they're just kind of dancing around a little bit too much, not playing assignment football perhaps. And that's what's got given up these big – these are chunk plays. You know, when you get 6, 7, 8 yards at a time, those are chunk plays, and you can't have that if you're down.
Both of these quarterbacks doing a great job reading these option plays. As this sets up second down and 3, short drop. Looked like he thought he might take off with it. Instead, he throws it into traffic, and it falls incomplete. Young fortunate to get that one back.
And looks like on Herschel Gregg had the best chance at catching that one. Linebacker for the Blue Ridge Yellow Jackets. Owen Young makes his first bad decision. He kind of pump faked, so you could tell he was thinking about it and decided to throw it anyway, and it was ill-advised, boy. And you cannot – Round Valley cannot continue to give Blue Ridge opportunities. They have done so. Blue Ridge is not capitalized, but you can't keep living by that mantra.
Third and 3, Wilbank is on the right. Gets the call, runs it to the left, trying to get it up, cutting up field, still on his feet at the 35 as he goes all the way down to the 39. He needed 3 yards, and he gained 8.
Boy, just a great job. You see him put his hand on his linebackers, and then any little seam, he just does a great job of running right through it. Just great concentration, size, and acceleration through the holes. Wilbank just really having his way. I know Round Valley likes to pass, but I'm giving it to Wilbank every single time until they show the ability to stop him.
That Mountain Mobile Auto Glass sends it to the 38. 6 minutes and 17 seconds left in the half. 6-0, Round Valley leading. Wilbank still out there on Young's right. Fake the handoff. This time Young's going to run it to the right side. He's got some blockers
but a nice
job there shedding some illegal blocks by both Marbello and Kern.
Yeah, Kern has done a great job of stepping up from his corner position, and you can see it right here on the replay. Great job right there. Clear block in the back as Kern did turn him back in for Marbello, but that's going to back him up.
Round Valley, 10-yard penalty, repeat 2.
Mr. Copeland doesn't sound the most excited out there
tonight.
He's
cold. We're all cold.
I'm feeling pretty good. I don't know.
I'm giving Big Daddy Chuck a pass on this one. 6 minutes and 4 seconds left in first and 20. A little bit of pressure shown by the Yellow Jackets, trying to run by that one with Wilbank as he gets strung out along the far side. Now turns it up over the 40. He's at midfield. He's got a couple of players in front of him, and he's forced out of bounds at the 40 by Mitchell.
Well, this time, P.J. Lennon does a poor job with the pursuit angle there, and it allows Wilbank to get to the outside. I think, you know, Wilbank, I think, is deceptively fast. You think, oh, I got him, and then he just outflanks you, gets to the outside, and just turns on the Jets. The Jackets got caught in a blitz right there. Round Valley ran away from it, and that's what allowed them to allow Wilbank to get to that secondary almost uncontested.
I'm giving him 31 yards on that one. That means he's at 94 on 10 carries. Mountain Mobile Auto Glass first down sends this to the Blue Ridge 38, and flags come out.
Prior to snap infraction, Round Valley.
Well, you know, you talked about these teams being well coached and the execution, but, you know, there's a lot more emotion in this one, a lot more to play for. You're talking about a region championship, and for Round Valley, who has not been in 3A, and now you're on one of your rivals' field.
Shotgun snap had by Young. As he starts moving the pocket to the right side, all sorts of purple there waiting for him as he's brought down at the 44 by Marbello. Couple of players late getting up, one of whom, they were both linemen.
Yeah, Ronan Palmer was late and kind of went over the top, but great pursuit. As you said, that was the first time I've really seen Blue Ridge come with some energy in their pursuit of Young. So we'll see if Young decides to give it to Wiltbank a few more times now.
Casey Mortensen was the running back that time as Wiltbank comes back out and will stand alongside Young. Three receivers going to the far side with Funaki down on the near side of the line of scrimmage. But the handoff does go to Wiltbank, and he runs right toward Funaki, gets to the far side of the field and is spun out of bounds. A little bit tardy, but there's no flag.
Well, and a great block to spring Wiltbank by Kyron Clark. He did a great job of picking up the would-be linebacker. Blue Ridge is bringing the blitz quite a few times. Round Valley has picked it up, and Blue Ridge not able to get there, and it leaves them vulnerable in the secondary. That's going to be a hard word to say in about a half an hour, I think. Harder word to say.
Let's go, boy!
35-yard line of the Yellow Jackets. Clock stopped at 5 minutes and 7 seconds. Third down and 6.
Let's go, boy!
Young trying to direct some traffic behind him as Wiltbank moves from the left to the right. Now puts a man in motion left to right. It's Hamblin. Fake the handoff to him as he starts moving the pocket to the left. Throws it into the flat, but it was wide. Clark, the intended receiver.
And Clark was open. He has been open all night, but Young just missed. There's no other another way to describe it. He had the time, but just missed. And so, but I'm 4th and 7. I'm thinking Blue Ridge has not really had much of success offensively. I'm going to go ahead and go for it, I think, but Round Valley is going to call timeout.
Round Valley will use its second timeout with 5 minutes and 3 seconds left here in the half, leading 6-0. It's Sholo Ford's presentation of high school football on iTalk 106.7 and iTalk1067.com.
Attention high school juniors and seniors. It's game time. Get ready to transform your life. Northland Pioneer College offers high school students the opportunity to earn college credit while in high school. Get ahead of the game. Complete college classes before you graduate. Visit npc.edu/advising to learn more. Northland Pioneer College, expanding minds, transforming lives.
Six nothing here at Blue Ridge, the number 3 Elk beating the number 6 Yellow Jackets. Getting a report from the number 2 Snowflake Lobos have no score against Payson.
That's surprising. Payson has taken their lumps this year. Not a horrible football team, but certainly they've been scored on quite a bit this year by these two teams for sure.
Fourth and a long 6. Looks like, oh no, I thought the hard count trying to draw him off. Is now Young takes the snap, rolls to the left. Now he's going to tuck it up, trying to stumble his way toward the 30, but I don't think he got enough as Franco Harris and Marbello stopped him a couple of yards short.
Well, I wouldn't be surprised if that was a designed run the whole way. Just roll Young out. If he happens to see something with the pass, great, but otherwise just try to get it with your feet. You know, you have the whole field in front of you. You had guys picking up blocks for you. You know, again, you got 4:55. Chances are Round Valley's thinking, oh, we're going to get the ball back again. The bad news is they only have one timeout.
Shotgun situation here with London, having Marbello on his left. Rolls to his left as he's trying to get a couple of blockers, but it is shed. Oh, he's still able to squeeze through a couple of would-be tacklers and have close to 10 yards there on that carry.
And now Blue Ridge, if they will run that play a few more times, that set up the RPO, you know, roll London out to that side, and when a linebacker comes up, you can dump it to the blocker out there. So nice pickup and a Mount Mobile out of glass first down.
Yeah, I said it was close to 10 yards, and 11 is very close to 10 yards.
It is, usually.
So I just thought he was on the wrong side.
You know, sometimes with COVID, you know, it's not quite. That's a math joke.
We're all a negative test series. There's 4:29 to go. 6-0 Round Valley leading, but the Yellow Jackets approaching midfield as Marbello gets the call, tries to find some space to the right of the line, but Hogle there plugs the hole and keeps him to just a yard.
Well, Round Valley has been a quick study here. They're starting to put some strength on the side that Blue Ridge is lining up to run that option, and so there's nobody there. I'm sorry, there's no way to for the lead guy to get a run through there, so P.J. London probably going to have to keep it here one of these times.
Second down and 9. Split backs going behind London, but now there's movement. Esparza moves from the left to the right as P.J. just keeps that one, goes right up his center's back and runs over the 50 and picks up 6 yards to set up third and short.
Interesting call. Haven't seen that one, but I'm sure they'll take it. Now the option play might be a good one to come to, or you could run the option pass if you can keep Round Valley out of your backfield.
Interestingly, Cisco off the field, the space-occupying nose guard. So that might have been something that London had seen and then exploited, as now Blue Ridge will take a timeout with 3 minutes and 22 seconds left, facing a big third and one. It's Sholo Ford's presentation of high school football on iTalk 106.7 and iTalk1067.com.
When you think glass, think Deemer's Glass in Lakeside. Deemer's Glass offers the best selection of quality glass with affordable prices. They do full home window packages, replacement windows, custom shower doors and enclosures, custom mirrors in many shapes, styles, and colors, glass doors and hardware, commercial glass for buildings and offices, skylights, screens, fire-rated glass for your fireplace or stove, window film, and more. Visit Deemer's Glass today on Porter Mountain Road in Lakeside or call 1-888-GLASSMAN.
D6.
He's big dude.
6-0, Round Valley is leading, but Blue Ridge with the football into Elk territory. And since that long drive, Round Valley not yet having been able to get back into the end zone. So I'm thinking Blue Ridge might be feeling like its defense is settled.
Blue Ridge is going to be feeling really good about the 6 points, only giving up the 6, because they really have held Round Valley for the most part in check. Wiltbank, you know, as soon as Round Valley started going away from Wiltbank is when they stopped gaining yards. Now, watch for Blue Ridge. I mean, if I'm Blue Ridge here, don't get too cute here.
Turn and hand it off to Mitchell, who's stopped in the backfield for a loss.
Nope,
Round Valley trying to make an argument that they picked up a fumble, but Cisco and Finocchi are there to get the stop.
I think he lost a yard.
Yes, he definitely was not getting positive yardage.
So here's the thing for Blue Ridge right now. It seems that when they go with their first man through, it's hitting the line faster. They're able to pick up positive yards. If they give it to Mitchell, the deep guy, Round Valley gets too much penetration upfield, and they just can't get anything going. So
fourth,
I would keep
and one,
giving it to that first guy.
I would keep an eye on some sort of shenanigans. Of course, the quarterback in London is the punter. Round Valley crowding the line here as he has a snap. It's had it, and he's going to try to tuck it, but he's got a little bit of space. Can he accelerate over the 45? He can. He's going to set it at the 40-yard line and picks up the Mountain Mobile Autoglass first down.
Well, good call, boys, on the fake punt. I'm surprised that's the one they went with, but I guess, you know, it's senior night. It's your last game. It's for the conference championship. You got to give it to your man. You got to give it to your stud, and they do so, and P.J. London makes it happen with no blockers out there, and Riley Hamlin, the only man that could stop him, and I'm surprised London outran him. Hamlin's got good wheels.
Picks up 8. I think that the man that he made miss in the flat was Merrill.
Oh, was it Merrill? Sorry.
So now first and 10 on the Round Valley 40. Hand this one off to Mitchell as he steps away from one tackler at the 40 and then gets all the way out to the 35, picks up 5.
Well, Jackets are trying to will themselves into the end zone right here. They got a long way to go still with 2:19. But Mitchell running hard. Like you said, he hasn't had a ton of carries so far. And he's had some good success when they run him, bounced into the outside. When they try to run him right up the middle, too much penetration for Round Valley. Well, they got to be calling timeout.
This has taken a long time to get out of the huddle. Nobody is counting yet.
I don't see the back judge counting. He's not even looking.
Turn and give to Mitchell. This time runs away from a tackler in the backfield, but Clark is able to stop him after a short gain of 1. But he, like was happening throughout the ball game yesterday, is having to do an awful lot of the lifting right as soon as he grabs the football.
Well, and if Blue Ridge has got to be thinking as far as clock management here. If we don't pick up this first, we have to let the clock run. Because if we don't pick up this first down right here, we're going to give Round Valley too much time. Now, if they pick up this first down, look for London to go to the air with the last minute in the half.
Minute and 24 seconds left. He's in the shotgun. Marbello's on his left. Takes the snap, starts rolling in this direction. Looks like he wants to pass. Now he's going to have some pressure as he's brought down eventually. Finocchi and Clark are there to bring him down all the way back toward midfield. He's going to get stopped at the 45.
Well, obviously, Round Valley coaches have saw something in the film room that they said, if you give P.J. London any time, he's going to hurt you. And so they are just bringing the house. They are not holding anything back. Ethan Marbello tried to step up and take on two oncoming rushers, but he just got crushed and right back into London. I think London was about to throw it, but he saw his own man being coming back at his knees and was like, oh, I can't do that. And it was just bad news. But just pinning their ears back, Round Valley is right now with great intensity.
Damon Mitchell with just 5 carries and 10 yards. He does have 2 extra touches on passes, but he has just 17 yards. And we said this during the opener that it's not necessarily wondering what you're going to get from London. We're seeing how you can try to get him into space even using fake punts.
Yeah.
It really feels like the Yellow Jackets got to get Mitchell involved a little bit more.
And ultimately it comes down to the front 5 offensively, 6 if you put the tight end in there for the Yellow Jackets. They're not giving Mitchell much of a seam. Not only that, they're not giving him a chance to get ahead of steam. Like he's encountering traffic before he gets to the line of scrimmage, and just no chance for him in that situation.
Blue Ridge called timeout to stop the clock as it ran down to 32 seconds. So
well, I don't know why they didn't just take a delay of game. But whatever, same thing. Yeah, I think both teams maybe are content to go into half right now, but. But you saw just what I said, you know, they didn't pick up the first down, and so now they don't give Round Valley a ton of time. Round Valley does have that one timeout.
Hamblin standing on his 15.
This will not be a fake.
There's a little bit of pressure, but a good kick from London as Hamblin signaling fair catch and brings that one down with a man in front of him. As this will set up the Elk with 25 seconds to work with, but 85 yards of field.
I'm guessing they're going to take a knee right here. I don't know. They might let Will Bank try. I mean, Owen Young try to air one out.
Will Bank looks like he's deeper than usual, as the Elk giving every indication that this will probably be a taken knee, and that is how it goes.
All right.
And both sides now making their way to the locker room as it's a tight one here. 6-0, Round Valley scored on its opening possession. And then both sides been pitching zeros since. We'll have our conversation for you right after this. It's Sheldon Ford's presentation of high school football on iTalk 106.7 and iTalk1067.com.
Who sells the number one truck in America? Sholo Ford. That's right. Not only do they sell it, Sholo Ford is the best place to buy it. Why? Guy Hatch guarantees it. In fact, he guarantees you'll get the best deal on your next Ford car, van, or SUV as well. It doesn't matter what you buy. Sholo Ford has the best deal. Sholo Ford on the east end of the Deuce and at SholoFord.com.
It's a tough game out there. We can help you reach your goals and come out victorious. Need help paying for college? Let the financial aid experts at North and Pioneer College help you qualify for federal, institutional, or tribal grants. See our website at npc.edu for details. Northland Pioneer College, expanding minds, transforming lives.
I got this.
Don't take time out of your busy day. Let Mountain Mobile Auto Glass come to you. All our technicians are certified by the National Auto Glass Safety Council. Mountain Mobile Auto Glass will give you $50 cash, free movie passes, and free dinner.
536-5972 Mountain Mobile Auto Glass. Cash back to you.
Orthodontist Dr. Joshua Beeler has been providing family-friendly orthodontics in Sholo and the entire White Mountains since 2006. If you need braces, stop in and see the friendly folks at Beeler Orthodontics and meet their professional staff. Dr. Beeler and his team have the latest in orthodontics technology, and they work with each patient individually to custom tailor the most effective treatment plan for the best results. Beeler Orthodontics is a proud sponsor of high school sports. Beeler Orthodontics, live to smile, love your smile.
Attention high school juniors and seniors, it's game time. Get ready to transform your life. Northland Pioneer College offers high school students the opportunity to earn college credit while in high school. Get ahead of the game. Complete college classes before you graduate. Visit npc.edu/advising to learn more. Northland Pioneer College, expanding minds, transforming lives.
You've been there, waiting forever at the gas station for the guy to free up so he can fill up your propane tank. Or worse, when the only qualified propane technician decided to stay home that day. Yep, you've been there and I have too. That's why now I get my propane from Ace Hardware every time. You get Ace Hardware's world-famous customer service when you stop in for propane. That's right, you get in, you get out, and you get a great deal on propane and everything else. From Ace Hardware at their locations in Pine Top and Heber. Ace Hardware is proud to support White Mountain Sports.
When you think glass, think Deemer's Glass in Lakeside. Deemer's Glass offers the best selection of quality glass with affordable prices. They do full home window packages, replacement windows, custom shower doors and enclosures, custom mirrors in many shapes, styles, and colors, glass doors and hardware, commercial glass for buildings and offices, skylights, screens, fire-rated glass for your fireplace or stove, window film, and more. Visit Deemer's Glass today on Porter Mountain Road in Lakeside or call 1-888-GLASSMAN.
Winning takes focus, preparation, and support. Keep focused on your dream career while saving thousands in tuition costs at Northland Pioneer College. We're here to support your goals and see you succeed. Visit npc.edu to see our programs. An academic advisor will get you on the right path to achieve your educational goals. Northland Pioneer College, expanding minds, transforming lives.
Summit Healthcare Regional Medical Center is a proud supporter of high school sports. Many of our local sports players were born at the hospital, where Summit Obstetrics offers comfortable individual rooms for mom and baby. In case of a sports injury, the hospital ER is always staffed and prepared to take on the most serious injuries, and Summit features an advanced diagnostics department with state-of-the-art equipment. The Summit Healthcare Orthopedic and Therapy teams can help sports players overcome injuries and return to the game. Summit Healthcare Regional Medical Center wishes all players a successful and healthy season this year.
Who sells the number one truck in America? Sholo Ford. That's right, not only do they sell it, Sholo Ford is the best place to buy it. Why? Guy Hatch guarantees it. In fact, he guarantees you'll get the best deal on your next Ford car, van, or SUV as well. It doesn't matter what you buy, Sholo Ford has the best deal. Sholo Ford on the east end of the Deuce and at SholoFord.com.
It's a tough game out there. We can help you reach your goals and come out victorious. Need help paying for college? Let the financial aid experts at Northland Pioneer College help you qualify for federal, institutional, or tribal grants. See our website at npc.edu for details. Northland Pioneer College, expanding minds, transforming lives.
As the score again, 6-0, Round Valley leading Blue Ridge at halftime. The ball game began with the Elk winning the toss and electing to defer to the second half, and it put PJ London, the Blue Ridge signal caller, into an advantageous circumstance after a big return from Jacob Kern got it deep into Round Valley territory. But the first play from scrimmage was London's head. It wound up going for a 25-yard loss. Then he was pressured on second down and an awful lot and wound up throwing a tip pass that was taken by Riley Hamblin and seemingly returned all the way down to the 10-yard line to set up a first and goal circumstance for the Elk. But instead, there was a block in the back, sent him all the way back to the 35-ish, which just started a six-minute drive that was a heavy dose of Seth Wiltbank, who over the course of that drive ran for 40 yards, but eventually an Owen Young strike between himself and Kyron Clark got the Elk into the end zone, though the extra point was not good. After that, it was just an awful lot of punts being exchanged. Round Valley at one point in the second quarter looked as if it had another drive operating, but wound up having that one stall, though it ought to be noted that Wiltbank right now is sitting on 101 yards unofficially on 11 carries. Blue Ridge looked as if it was winning the field position battle and seemed as if they were finally going to benefit from that when the Yellow Jackets got a huge run from Franco Harris on his first carry in the second quarter. He went for 30 yards and pushed the ball deep into Round Valley territory, but that one also stalled as the Elk were able to pick up a stop again, doing something that was going to be a theme throughout this first half, getting into the backfield as the Round Valley front is using both its speed and size advantages to really make life difficult, especially for P.J. London. But he's not getting an awful lot of help on the ground. Damon Mitchell has 5 carries and just 10 yards. Ethan Marbello has just 2 carries and 2 yards. Franco Harris has that 30-yard bounce, but otherwise only 9 yards on his 2 other carries. And it just has been hard for the Yellow Jackets to try to come up with a formula that is able to deal with the size and speed off of the Round Valley front. On the other side of it, Owen Young is 3 for 9 for 34 yards. 2 of his 3 completions occurred in that first drive. But otherwise, as the temperature continues to descend, it's down to 43 degrees here at 8:01 p.m. at halftime on a homecoming day here for the Blue Ridge Yellow Jackets. It's been a little bit tougher to really grip the football and try to find anybody open downfield. But fortunately for Round Valley, they've been able to lean on Seth Wiltbank, who has those 101 aforementioned yards, and Owen Young also doing it himself as he has 30 yards on 7 carries. 6-0 here at halftime. Round Valley leading at intermission, and we'll have the football to start. This is Sholo Ford's presentation of high school football on iTalk 106.7 and iTalk1067.com.
I got this.
Don't take time out of your busy day. Let Mountain Mobile Auto Glass come to you. All our technicians are certified by the National Auto Glass Safety Council. Mountain Mobile Auto Glass will give you $50 cash, free movie passes, and free
just call
dinner.
536-5972. Mountain Mobile Auto Glass. Cash back to you.
Orthodontist Dr. Joshua Beeler has been providing family-friendly orthodontics in Sholo and the entire White Mountains since 2006. If you need braces, stop in and see the friendly folks at Beeler Orthodontics and meet their professional staff. Dr. Beeler and his team have the latest in orthodontics technology, and they work with each patient individually to custom-tailor the most effective treatment plan for the best results. Beeler Orthodontics is a proud sponsor of high school sports. Beeler Orthodontics, live to smile, love your smile.
Attention high school juniors and seniors, it's game time. Get ready to transform your life. Northland Pioneer College offers high school students the opportunity to earn college credit while in high school. Get ahead of the game. Complete college classes before you graduate. Visit npc.edu/advising to learn more. Northland Pioneer College, expanding minds, transforming lives.
You've been there, waiting forever at the gas station for the guy to free up so he can fill up your propane tank. Or worse, when the only qualified propane technician decided to stay home that day. Yep, you've been there and I have too. That's why now I get my propane from Ace Hardware every time. You get Ace Hardware's world-famous customer service when you stop in for propane. That's right, you get in, you get out, and you get a great deal on propane and everything else from Ace Hardware at their locations in Pine Top and Heber. Ace Hardware is proud to support White Mountain Sports.
When you think glass, think Deemer's Glass in Lakeside. Deemer's Glass offers the best selection of quality glass with affordable prices. They do full home window packages, replacement windows, custom shower doors and enclosures, custom mirrors in many shapes, styles, and colors, glass doors and hardware, commercial glass for buildings and offices, skylights, screens, fire-rated glass for your fireplace or stove, window film, and more. Visit Deemer's Glass today on Porter Mountain Road in Lakeside or call 1-888-GLASSMAN.
Winning takes focus, preparation, and support. Keep focused on your dream career while saving thousands in tuition costs at Northland Pioneer College. We're here to support your goals and see you succeed. Visit npc.edu to see our programs. An academic advisor will get you on the right path to achieve your educational goals. Northland Pioneer College, expanding minds, transforming lives.
Summit Healthcare Regional Medical Center is a proud supporter of high school sports. Many of our local sports players were born at the hospital, where Summit Obstetrics offers comfortable individual rooms for mom and baby. In case of a sports injury, the hospital ER is always staffed and prepared to take on the most serious injuries, and Summit features an advanced diagnostics department with state-of-the-art equipment. The Summit Healthcare Orthopedic and Therapy teams can help sports players overcome injuries and return to the game. Summit Healthcare Regional Medical Center wishes all players a successful and healthy season this year.
Who sells the number one truck in America? Sholo Ford. That's right. Not only do they sell it, Sholo Ford is the best place to buy it. Why? Guy Hatch guarantees it. In fact, he guarantees you'll get the best deal on your next Ford car, van, or SUV as well. It doesn't matter what you buy. Sholo Ford has the best deal. Sholo Ford on the east end of the Deuce and at SholoFord.com.
It's a tough game out there. We can help you reach your goals and come out victorious. Need help paying for college? Let the financial aid experts at Northland Pioneer College help you qualify for federal, institutional, or tribal grants. See our website at npc.edu for details. Northland Pioneer College, expanding minds, transforming lives.
I got this.
Don't take time out of your busy day. Let Mountain Mobile Auto Glass come to you. All our technicians are certified by the National Auto Glass Safety Council. Mountain Mobile Auto Glass will give you $50 cash, free movie passes, and free dinner.
536-5972 Mountain Mobile Auto Glass. Cash back to you.
Six nothing Round Valley leading at Blue Ridge. This is the number 3 Round Valley Elk and the number 6 Blue Ridge Yellow Jackets. As this was the debut of the power rankings coming up on the last week of the season, 2020. She's weird. But we'll go ahead and break down all 16 teams for you here, as there's an awful lot of 3A East action, as one would expect. But number 1, Yuma Catholic, 6-0, and with more than 19 power points, which is almost a full 5 more than number 2 Snowflake. Snowflake garnering that number 2 ranking in large part because it has wins against American Leadership Academy Gilbert North, which is number 5. Thatcher, which is number 13, and of course won on this field against the number 6 Blue Ridge Yellow Jackets. So number 2, despite having lost to Round Valley, which checks in at number 3 with a 5-1 record, the lone loss for the Elk, of course, against Safford by a lonely 2 points. Safford checks in as the number 8 team. Number 4, Valley Christian, currently leading Sholo 14-0, as they are the number 4 team, as well as the aforementioned American Leadership Academy Gilbert North at 5. Blue Ridge, as we've been saying all night, at 6. Push Ridge from down in Tucson is number 7. Just talked about Safford at 8, but Wickenburg Wranglers, the first team to check in the rankings with 2 losses at number 9. Phoenix Christian, which joined Round Valley from coming up from the 2A ranks, is at number 10. Arizona College Prep, also 4-2, checks in at 11. River Valley from the west side of the state is number 12, also with a 4-2 record. Mentioned Thatcher. The Eagles are at 3-3 and 13th in these power rankings. Dysart has only been able to get 4 games in, but they are at number 2. They're from the west side of Phoenix. Coolidge, a familiar name, but just a 3-3 record and number 15 in the power rankings. And Bourget Catholic, another team that had played Snowflake and had lost to the Lobos last week. So that's 4 of the top 16 that Snowflake was able to get. The way this is going to work, of course, is 1 through 16 will be admitted. 1 through 8 are going to host next week, and then the higher seed the following week before things go to a neutral site. So one would expect that there's going to be 3 teams from the White Mountain area that are going to be hosting, especially Snowflake, Round Valley, and Blue Ridge. It's any guess who they would be matched up with, but if things were just broken down with the power rankings to set them up, you'd have the Lobos facing up against Coolidge. Coolidge, of course, historically is very big and fast. That might be a potentially tough matchup. Round Valley would be matched up with Dysart. Don't know an awful lot about those guys. And Blue Ridge would be playing host to Arizona College Prep. So it sets up a really interesting circumstance if everything went as chalk, with Round Valley getting matched up on a neutral site against Snowflake. The Lobos probably anxious for a little bit of an opportunity to get some revenge. And perhaps most importantly, all three of the teams from the 3A East that we spent a lot of time talking about would not necessarily have to play Yuma Catholic before the championship game, though it ought to be noted that Yuma Catholic would have a quarterfinal matchup potentially with Safford, and that just might be a tough matchup. Word is the Shamrocks like to sling it, and Safford, much like Thatcher down there in the Gila Valley, likes to play pretty big. But, of course, all of this is subject to change after the final weekend is played. The playoffs will start next week when, according to the extended forecast, it is supposed to be a little bit warmer. So count this guy as being a little bit grateful for such a thing. As it is chilly right now and halftime winding down, but 6-0, Round Valley leading and is poised to receive the opening kick to start the second half of play, and we'll have it for you right after this. It's Sholo Ford's presentation of high school football on iTalk 106.7 and iTalk1067.com.
Who sells the number one truck in America? Sholo Ford. That's right. Not only do they sell it, Sholo Ford is the best place to buy it. Why? Guy Hatch guarantees it. In fact, he guarantees you'll get the best deal on your next Ford car, van, or SUV as well. It doesn't matter what you buy. Sholo Ford has the best deal. Sholo Ford on the east end of the Deuce and at sholoford.com.
It's a tough game out there. We can help you reach your goals and come out victorious. Need help paying for college? Let the financial aid experts at Northland Pioneer College help you qualify for federal, institutional, or tribal grants. See our website at npc.edu for details. Northland Pioneer College, expanding minds, transforming lives.
I got this.
Don't take time out of your busy day. Let Mountain Mobile Auto Glass come to you. All our technicians are certified by the National Auto Glass Safety Council. Mountain Mobile Auto Glass will give you $50 cash, free movie passes, and free dinner.
536-5972 Mountain Mobile Auto Glass. Cash back to you.
Orthodontist Dr. Joshua Beeler has been providing family-friendly orthodontics in Sholo and the entire White Mountains since 2006. If you need braces, stop in and see the friendly folks at Beeler Orthodontics and meet their professional staff. Dr. Beeler and his team have the latest in orthodontics technology, and they work with each patient individually to custom tailor the most effective treatment plan for the best results. Beeler Orthodontics is a proud sponsor of high school sports. Beeler Orthodontics, live to smile, love your smile.
Attention high school juniors and seniors, it's game time. Get ready to transform your life. Northland Pioneer College offers high school students the opportunity to earn college credit while in high school. Get ahead of the game. Complete college classes before you graduate. Visit npc.edu/advising to learn more. Northland Pioneer College, expanding minds, transforming lives.
You've been there, waiting forever at the gas station for the guy to free up so he can fill up your propane tank. Or worse, when the only qualified propane technician decided to stay home that day. Yep, you've been there and I have too. That's why now I get my propane from Ace Hardware every time. You get Ace Hardware's world-famous customer service when you stop in for propane. That's right, you get in, you get out, and you get a great deal on propane and everything else from Ace Hardware at their locations in Pine Top and Heber. Ace Hardware is proud to support White Mountain Sports.
When you think glass, think Deemer's Glass in Lakeside. Deemer's Glass offers the best selection of quality glass with affordable prices. They do full home window packages, replacement windows, custom shower doors and enclosures, custom mirrors in many shapes, styles, and colors, glass doors and hardware, commercial glass for buildings and offices, skylights, screens, fire-rated glass for your fireplace or stove, window film, and more. Visit Deemer's Glass today on Porter Mountain Road in Lakeside or call 1-888-GLASSMAN.
Winning takes focus, preparation, and support. Keep focused on your dream career while saving thousands in tuition costs at Northland Pioneer College. We're here to support your goals and see you succeed. Visit npc.edu to see our programs. An academic advisor will get you on the right path to achieve your educational goals. Northland Pioneer College, expanding minds, transforming lives.
We'll be right back. 6-0 Round Valley leading. Getting ready to start the second half. The Elk won the toss and elected to defer. If you're just joining us, the Elk picked off a P.J. London pass on the opening drive and then went 35 yards over 6 minutes to get the only score of the ball game. That first drive was a heavy doses of Seth Wiltbank, who has about 101 yards on 11 carries. Owen Young also with 30 yards on 7 carries. That has been most of the Round Valley offense as Mike Granillo, who is just reading the homecoming stuff, rejoins me here. I'm going to go so far as to speculate that one of the reasons why we haven't seen as much Wiltbank as you have been prescribing is because they're trying to save him for this second half.
Well, that's not a bad theory, but now you've allowed Blue Ridge time to make adjustments. That's the only problem. You might have had an opportunity to be up 2 or 3 scores had you gone with Wiltbank, and then now the adjustments are like in panic mode. Now Blue Ridge, you know, they're only down 6-0. If they can come out and get a stop here, you know, they're going to be geared up for Wiltbank, I assume. And so, you know, Blue Ridge has to feel like they're in this ball game, and that's not a good place for, you know, if you're a Round Valley fan, that's not where you want Blue Ridge to be right now, because Round Valley's really dominated the game, I feel like.
Yeah. It's time for the Northland Pioneer College kickoff. When it comes time to kick off your college education, choose the college with the lowest tuition in the state of Arizona. Only $40 a credit hour. That's Northland Pioneer College. As this is the first time that we have seen this look from the Elk, as they got Hamblin, Ortiz, and a third. I can't see who is on the far side. It might be Rivera. Might be Wiltbank, too. As London, who does all of the kicking duties for the Yellow Jackets, puts a boot into this one, and it's angling toward Hamblin here on the near sideline, cuts it toward the hash. Now he's trying to get to the far side. He's got
and
some
he
space as he gets over the 25-30. He gets to the 35 before Martinez brings him down out of bounds, but his momentum and inertia takes him all the way up to the 38 and a big return to start the second half for the Elk.
Well, that's a great return by Hamblin, and you got to figure that was an intentional kickoff, not to go to Seth Wiltbank, but to come to the other side of the field to Riley Hamblin. But Hamblin makes him pay, goes all the way across the field. And, you know, it's an unorthodox return, as you said, Derek. But Round Valley makes it work with those athletes they have out there.
This is the best field position that the Elk have boasted in a long time. Spent most of that first half after that opening drive deep in their own territory. Now they got Wiltbank on the right of Young, who's in the shotgun, and he gets the call. Goes right up the middle, over the 40-yard line, over the 45, still on his feet as he's at midfield and dives into Blue Ridge territory on a huge gainer there for Wiltbank, who was being contacted almost as soon as he got his hands on that one, but gains 13 yards and a Mountain Mobile Autoglass third down.
Well, here's the problem for Blue Ridge is that everybody in the whole zip code knew that ball was going to Seth Wiltbank, and Blue Ridge couldn't stop it. They had him at the line of scrimmage, but Wiltbank just powered through a couple arm tackles and made a statement run there on that opening play.
Finaki's in the backfield. Three receivers set as when Finaki gets the call and is met as soon as he gets his hands on that one and is stood up by Keisler.
You know, that's the only thing that I question from Coach Bell is, like, you have this formula that works, and but Funaki is not it. I mean, he's a big kid, but he has to have a head of steam to do some damage, and he obviously did not have it there.
He's stopped for no gain. Second down and 10 with the clock under 11 minutes to go in the third. 6-0 Round Valley leading and at midfield. This time Young's going to keep this one, goes to the right of the line, but he is stood up by one of the Yellow Jackets after a short gain.
I know that might have been it. Was it Herschel Gregg? Herschel Gregg there on the tackle. So, again, now look, they went to Wiltbank, got 12 yards or whatever. Now they haven't gone to Wiltbank, and they only have 2. So, I know you have to keep your defense honest. You have to, you know, mix it up a little bit. But this is still high school football. And until Blue Ridge shows the ability to stop Seth Wiltbank, I got to give him the ball.
Third down and 8.
Although they might pass it here.
Passing situation, but it's chilly. Funaki is up, and they give it instead to Wiltbank, who's again forced to the outside, but he curves it around the blockers, and he gets over the 35 down to the 33. P.J. London eventually brings him down, as that time Wiltbank just used all of his athleticism to pick up
12 yards and a Mountain Mobile Auto Glass first down.
And that's the problem is we have called P.J. London's name way too many times on the defensive side of the ball, and he's the free safety. So you know if it's getting to his level where he has to come up and make the play that it's big yards. And as you said, Derek Wilbank, nothing going in the designed play hole, so he bounces it to the outside and just outruns everybody.
Still on Young's right, 9:50 to go, 6-0 Round Valley leading and moving as this time Young pitches this one out. Late pitch, but it's had by Wilbank, but there's a great job by Blue Ridge to swarm around the option, but still Wilbank is able to get toward the 30 and maybe pick up 5 yards on what looked like was going to go for very little gain.
And I don't know if they still teach this, but I know when I was with Blue Ridge, if a quarterback is going to run an option like that, you hammer him when he pitches the ball. And I think Young took a pretty good shot right there, so he may be more apt to give that up a little sooner next time.
Second down and five. Scrimmage the Blue Ridge 30. Wilbank standing on Young's left and gets the call. Again, forced to move as soon as he approaches the line of scrimmage, but this time a great job by a couple of Yellow Jackets to stop him before he gets to the outside. Marbello and Muncy were there to stop him for a very short gain.
Yeah, I think they've seen that move before. Has Marbello specifically, where Wilbank tries to bait you to the inside, and then he bounces it to the outside, and that time Marbello just able to get enough of a foot in order to bring him down. But I'm guessing Wilbank's going to get the ball again here.
Third and five. As Wilbank waiting in the backfield. No, they fake the give, throw it over the top. It's hit by Clark, but he fumbles it, and I think they're going to say it was incomplete.
Yeah, I think he did not control it long enough, but a big hit. I didn't see who put the hit on him. It might have been Kern, but well-timed and
let
great.
Me tell you, that was a fumble. I couldn't see who had the hit again, but he caught that, and he turned, and he put it upfield, and he had two steps.
But the play action worked really well that time. Fooled Marbello, who was in the thing. Yeah, PJ, that could have been a fumble, but there's no instant replay in high school football. But we have it here for you.
That was probably the Deemer's glass-shattering hit of the game, or at least it's the leader here in the third quarter. As they're going for it on fourth and five, fake the handoff is there, now trying to roll it out to the right side is Young, but Marbello tracks him down at the 34 for a loss of four.
That's a big play for the Blue Ridge Yellow Jackets. And really, Marbello is the one he's kind of been beat to the outside quite a bit tonight. But this time, he just stays home long enough. That was a great play fake by Owen Young, but a better play. And just the intensity, you could just see the desire for Marbello to go and get Young, and he does so and come up with a big play from
Marbello
the Yellow
Jackets. Marbello with two huge plays. They're stopping Wilbank on second and five before he could get to the outside, and then they're tracking down Young for a loss of what's going to be ruled to be just 3 yards. But Blue Ridge taking over with 8 minutes and 25 seconds left, trailing just 6-0. Here is London with the give to Mitchell, but is again going to be wrapped up by an awful lot of humanity as he gets just a yard.
It's very hard for us to see from here, but I don't know what's going on at that line, but they are getting no movement at all. There's no drive by the offensive lineman for the Blue Ridge Yellow Jackets on the Round Valley defensive front. They're just getting no penetration, so they're leaving everything up to Mitchell, and it's kind of hard when you're 1-on-3.
They're going to say he pushed it out for a 2-yard gain.
That's generous.
Yes. As he, Mitchell again in the backfield, now all sorts of motion as split backs come up really close to the line of scrimmage. And Marbello, they fake the give as London's going to kick this one outside. He's got a lead blocker in front of him as Mitchell then loses the football, but London might have fallen back on it.
Oh, boy. That would have been disastrous.
Oof. Mountain Mobile Auto Glass first down as London runs for 12 yards and then fumbles it forward for another one or two. It looks like they're going to have him spotted at the 49.
Yeah, Ortiz hanging on for dear life right there on that tackle because London was – he had a lot of determination in that run and great execution by Blue Ridge on that play.
Already at the line of scrimmage of the Yellow Jackets, turn and give to Mitchell, who's again met at the line of scrimmage. He is falling forward to the 45 and picks up 3 yards, but now the Yellow Jackets, after dodging a bullet with that fumble, have a little bit of a drive going.
Yeah, trying to get up to the line of scrimmage as fast as they can, as you say, probably just to keep the momentum going, not allow Round Valley to catch their breath, no substitutions, but now they've stalled, and now they're taking a long time to get the play in. Second and long, I got to believe they got to run it one more time here.
6:50 to go here in the third, 6-0.
Round Valley leads, but the Yellow Jackets in Elk territory as Linda goes under center, hands off Mitchell, who's again forced to make some men miss in the backfield, and then dives to the 40 after it looked like he was going to get stopped for no gain. Damon Mitchell picks up another four.
Arona in there on the tackle along with Funaki, but great individual efforts. So now we're seeing the intensity that I think Blue Ridge thought they were going to come out in the game with, especially on senior night and all that. This game should not be as close as it is, but Blue Ridge is going to try to take advantage of that here in the second half.
Third down and one on the Round Valley 40. Again, turning and giving to Mitchell, who's again met at the line of scrimmage and stopped at the line this time for no gain. Owen Young and Clark were there, and it's decision time here for the Yellow Jackets.
Oh, it is decision time. I'm not sure what they're going to do. If I'm Blue Ridge, I'm going for it. Because you have to make a statement at some point that we can pick up a yard.
All right, I'm going to go with the con here. Okay. If I'm Blue Ridge, I'm punting it because they've been playing great defensively since that first drive, and you can go ahead and turn that field position.
But you got to score 6 points at some point. At some point, you got to move the ball enough. It does turn the field. It does flip the field. You're right.
It looks as if Coach London is in agreement with you as he's got London set up. Oh, okay, they're just going in motion. I thought there was going to be a procedure flag. Is London with the keeper moving to the near side, and he's going to be able to turn the corner, get to the 35. Now he's in space. He's at the 20, the 10, the 5. Touchdown, but a flag is out.
Hold the phone.
A flag was thrown up.
Where is the flag?
Back toward the 10 or 15-yard line. It's on the sideline at the 17-yard line. So,
well, great execution, great block on the outside. Franco Harris actually picked off two defenders.
I didn't see. What was the call?
Holding. It is holding, but it's going to be from the spot, so it is still going to be a first down.
It would have been good to get into the end zone from 40, but the spot foul will be a Mountain Mobile Autoglass first down to the 27.
My guess is what happened is it was probably on Riley Hamblin. He was coming over to make that play on London, and then when London cut it back inside, Hamlin tried to turn and come back, and he probably got held at that moment. I mean, it's almost a no-win situation for a receiver in that situation.
5:15 to go in the third. A touchdown pulled off the board. Still 6-0 game for Round Valley as London hands off to Franco, who's able to surge and lose a helmet. He goes all the way down to the 24 and picks up 5 yards. And when that helmet came off, my first reaction was the football had rolled free.
Well, Franco has done a lot, done some good work inside tonight, running those hard yards. And Blue Ridge does seem to have a little momentum, and they're finally starting to get a little push. You know, defensive lines tend to wear out.
Marbello with the call as he has a pretty big push down to the 20 and sets up another third and short.
And this is what Blue Ridge tries to predicate things on, is getting that just a line surge. You got to get a line surge because you got to get 2 or 3 yards at least. And so Round Valley is a little bit on their heels right now. And at some point, though, I got to believe play action is coming with P.J. London going to try to throw one to the end zone. Third and short, probably not the time to do it. They're probably going to keep running it.
Round Valley getting a little bit bigger as Rowdy Rivera comes out. Now fake the handoff as there is London pulling it back and going to the far side of the field and into the end zone for the score. Touchdown, Blue Ridge.
Everybody was very hesitant to cheer because it looked so like it almost looked like the play was called dead because nobody knew that London had the ball except for London and a couple receivers. So that's a huge play, and I had said at some point they're going to run play action, and there it was, and it did suck in the entire Round Valley defense. Nobody back there as London goes in untouched, and now this becomes a huge extra point right here.
London's had a huge day kicking it, but it's been all with the punting as he was responsible for pinning Round Valley deep so much of the time. Now, after the Elk missed an extra point on the first possession offensively for Round Valley, can London make him pay here as the snap is down, the kick is away, and it's good. So the Yellow Jackets with their first lead, 7-6, with 3 minutes and 58 seconds to play in the third quarter. It's Solo Ford's presentation of high school football at iTalk 106.7 or iTalk1067.com.
You are clear.
Summit Healthcare Regional Medical Center is a proud supporter of high school sports. Many of our local sports players were born at the hospital where Summit opts to...
I think I'm going to have to go pee off the fence here, off the bleachers. Wow, isn't that interesting?
Attention high school juniors and seniors. It's game time. Get ready to transform your life. Northland Pioneer College offers high school students the opportunity to earn college credit while in high school. Get ahead of the game. Complete college classes before you graduate. Visit npc.edu/advising to learn more. Northland Pioneer College, expanding minds, transforming lives.
In it.
Thanks, Ashley. Thanks,
Ashley. Here comes your audio.
Blue Ridge leading 7-6 after keeping it exclusively on the ground, after stopping the Elk on a 4th and 5. And now it is Round Valley, which has not scored since its first possession on this Northland Pioneer College kickoff. Has this one caroming off of Hamblin's shoulder pad, but he's eventually able to get it now. He's got a little bit of room to run as he gets into the 24, maybe the 26-yard line. It's time for the Northland Pioneer College kickoff. When it's time to kick off your college education, choose the college with the lowest tuition in the state of Arizona. Only $40 per credit hour. It's Northland Pioneer College. So the Elk are in need now of a jolt.
Well, and we know that they have a high-powered offense, and they can do that. The other thing is, you know, both these teams have had tough – their only loss have been tough losses, you know. And so now feelings of that start to creep in a little bit. Round Valley lost by 2 to Safford. Blue Ridge lost by 1 to Snowflake. So turning point for sure.
3 receivers set. Clark now going in motion and stopping behind the line of scrimmage to serve as another blocker as they hand it off to Wilt Bank. He goes away from him, gets to the 27-yard line, and great pursuit there by P.J. London to stop him after a 3-yard gain.
Well, that's a long way for London to come on that, but he is obviously one of the adjustments Blue Ridge made is to commit to stopping the run. They didn't do so on Wilt Bank's first carry of the second half, but they do so there. And if that could be a problem for Round Valley. If they can't keep Wilt Bank going, they really haven't had much success doing much else, with the maybe the exception of throwing it to Kyron Clark.
But that was before the temperature really started to descend.
Right.
As here in a passing situation, potentially, 2nd and a short 8. Got 2 backs on either side of Young. First time that we've seen this look as the handoff is faked. And now throwing it over the top where Rivera wasn't looking for it.
Nice design play, though, RPO. But perhaps Young rode Wilt Bank just a little too long. However, Rivera wasn't even looking. So miscommunication for sure on that one. I haven't seen Round Valley run that play just yet, but obviously something they have in the bag of tricks.
Now a big 3rd down. They're still calling it 8.
Yeah, it's a short 8.
You have screens.
Kyron Clark just come off the sideline for Round Valley. He's going to line up split wide to the right with Hamblin.
This is his down. This is Kyron Clark's down. I don't know why he's out.
Now Rivera, as they fake the look over to Rivera, now going to the far side where Ortiz is nearly able to bring that one in. And they're going to say that was well defended, but I thought that probably could have warranted a pass interference flag.
I thought so, too, because was that Cody Wallace on the coverage? Cody Wallace never looked back for the ball, and that's one of the rules. Now, I don't know.
Well, not only did he not look for it, there was some contact before the ball got there, too.
But yeah, that's a tough call.
80 yards on penalties for Round Valley. Funaki kicks this one short. Bounces at the 40 and then rolls toward the 32. Just 5 penalty yards for Blue Ridge in the first half. And I think the Round Valley fans might be okay to go ahead and break something tasteful after that one.
Yeah,
especially with those penalty stats.
That was a tough one. The play action didn't really fool Wallace a whole lot, but the ball perhaps just a hair underthrown, and that allowed Wallace to catch up to it. But Young has thrown pretty good balls. His receivers just have not been able to come up with it.
So after keeping it on the ground to get in the end zone, 2 minutes and 44 seconds left in the 3rd. 7-6, Blue Ridge leading Round Valley. And PJ set to go under center. He's got Mitchell in the backfield behind him.
turn. Instead, give it up to Harris, who's able to bounce off of one tackler and hang on to the football as he dives out for a 6-yard gain on first down.
Not only was that dangerous as far as a fumble goes, but that was, Franklin Harris was very close to breaking that one. He almost kept his feet as he was spun around, and then he picked up some blocks. But good positive yards for the Yellow Jackets on first down.
Second down and 4. Split backs again behind London, who this time turns and gives to Mitchell, who cuts this one up and has enough for a Mountain Mobile Auto Glass first down after a 5-yard gain.
The Yellow Jacket sideline is fired up. They're playing with a lot more energy here in this second half. They found some new life, and it has been keyed by their offensive line, getting a good push on the Round Valley front.
Scrimmage is the Blue Ridge 43. Kern goes wide to the right as London goes under center, again with split backs behind him. Handed off to Harris, who is this time going to be stood up a little bit more quickly. Merrill there with the stop and just a 1-yard gain.
So good. That was just a great individual effort by Merrill, because the rest of the line got shoved back about 5 yards, but Merrill was able to sneak through there and stop Harris, which is not easy to do one-on-one. Merrill giving up some pounds on that one.
Second down and 9.
This is where you want Blue Ridge right now. Second down, long, third and long.
Yellow Jackets with a bit of a psych as they broke huddle and then went back, and now are back at the line of scrimmage. Handed off to Marbello, who's met at the line of scrimmage and stopped for another 1-yard gain to make it third and long.
Yeah, and that's the thing. That's what I was going to get at, is that that's a tough place for Blue Ridge to play from, I think, because they have not shown the ability to slow down the pass rush of the Round Valley Elks, and now you put P.J. Lund in an obvious pass situation.
Third and 8, not yet to air it out here in the second half. And fake the handoff as he is going to be pressured by Ortiz, but he's able to get away from that one, but then running backwards is brought down by Owen Young for a huge loss.
Yep, and that's the problem. No one blocked Ortiz, and he came free on a safety blitz, on a corner blitz actually, and then Young was able to finish him off. I don't know how London got out of the first tackle, but that's a pretty big play, because now Round Valley does have the opportunity to flip the field on Blue Ridge.
Going to be a 10-yard loss.
And Round Valley just has too many athletes to run plays that take a long time to develop. And it would have been better off just to go ahead and give that.
But I think what was worse is not only did it take a long time to develop, it fooled absolutely nobody, least of all Jovan Ortiz. First time we've really called his name today, but he comes up with a huge stop with his team trailing 7-6. There's going to be one quarter to go after this. It's Solo Ford's presentation of high school football on iTalk 106.7 and iTalk1067.com.
Orthodontist Dr. Joshua Beeler has been providing family-friendly orthodontics in Sholo and the entire White Mountains since 2006. If you need braces, stop in and see the friendly folks at Beeler Orthodontics and meet their professional staff. Dr. Beeler and his team have the latest in orthodontics technology, and they work with each patient individually to custom tailor the most effective treatment plan for the best results. Beeler Orthodontics is a proud sponsor of high school sports. Beeler Orthodontics, live to smile, love your smile.
Seven to six, Blue Ridge now in front of Round Valley. And Mike, it feels like at this point the biggest difference between these two teams is the Yellow Jackets a little bit more comfortable playing one-dimensionally. Without the air attack for Round Valley, there's just not as quite a dynamic an offense.
And I think Coach Bell is still tempted to throw the ball, but it's tough out there. That ball has got to feel like a rock out there. And PJ's going to have to punt it. That's going to feel real good. But, yeah, you're right. I mean, Blue Ridge is content to run the ball, although they did try to pass it on that last third down play.
Hamblin standing between his 30 and 35-yard lines. A great kick there by London. And it's off a shoulder pad from Hamblin, who could not handle it, and it's recovered by the Yellow Jackets.
And in there on the recovery is Austin Slaughter, I believe, the senior, coming up big. But really, that's just a huge mental error by Riley Hamblin. You know, ball is hot, is cold. It's probably a little moist. There's a little bit of wind starting to pick up, and he just misplayed that off the shoulder pad. And, oh, that's a tough one for the young man.
So bring the Yellow Jacket offense back out there. Marbello is in the backfield alongside London as they're going to roll the pocket that way. He's looking to keep it, but a huge play again in the backfield by Finocchi.
Well, Funaki repaying the favor. The one time he ran the ball, he got stood up and crushed pretty good, and he able to get in the backfield. Just great. I mean, nobody, they just can't. They don't seem to be able to block Round Valley unless it's a straight-ahead, quick-hitting play. Anything to the outside or a PJ wants to try to throw, they just cannot give him any kind of time.
Second down and 12. Kern splitting wide to the right as they turn and give to Mitchell, who picks his way through traffic and is able to spin forward, pick up all the lost yardage, maybe even gain one more, but it's another third and long play.
It is a third and long. Now, here's something to think about, though, is are you in field goal range? Because Blue Ridge has had the answer defensively for Round Valley, except for that first drive of the game. And so a field goal might be the difference here. Blue Ridge has got to be smart here, try to pick up some positive yards, and maybe give P.J. London, although he would be kicking into the wind, an opportunity.
Two receivers, Esparza and Kern, coming out wide to the right. Split backs alongside London, who fakes the handoff, throws this one out to Esparza. He has a – no, it's going to be incomplete. So stop play with 10:34 to go. It'll be fourth and eight, and this would be somewhere in the neighborhood of a 45-yard field goal.
Yeah, I don't think so. I think that's what I'm saying. You had to pick up, you know, positive yards. You had to get close to that first down marker to make it inside a 40-yard field goal. But outside of 40, into the wind, I just don't think on a cold night, I don't think that's the way to go. But here you see the confidence Blue Ridge has in their defense as they're going for it.
Again with split backs on either side of London from the shotgun. Two receivers again, Esparza and Kern to the right, looking in that direction. Wind it up and throw this one. Caught by Esparza. He's got a first down as he gets it inside the 10 after the catch.
Well, I tell you what. There's been a big knock on the Blue Ridge Yellow Jacket receivers this season, not being able to catch the ball that sometimes London throws, but this time Esparza, not only does he catch it, but does a great job of concentrating enough to turn up field and pick up the necessary yards. Huge pickup. That might be our Beeler Orthodontic straight line play of the game.
That is not quite inside the 10. It's an 18-yard gain to the 11, and the whistle blows.
Timeout, Blue Ridge.
We'll take it with him. The Yellow Jackets fortunate after the muffed punt and are now threatening, leading 7-6. It's Sholo Ford's presentation of high school football on iTalk 106.7 and iTalk1067.com.
You've been there, waiting forever at the gas station for the guy to free up so he can fill up your propane tank. Or worse, when the only qualified propane technician decided to stay home that day. Yep, you've been there and I have too. That's why now I get my propane from Ace Hardware every time. You get Ace Hardware's world-famous customer service when you stop in for propane. That's right, you get in, you get out, and you get a great deal on propane and everything else from Ace Hardware at their locations in Pine Top and Heber. Ace Hardware is proud to support White Mountain Sports.
7-6, Blue Ridge leading and having used its first timeout.
It's so funny to see how calm Coach Lennon is these days, because when he wasn't the head coach, not so calm.
His son PJ going under center on first and 10. Handoff, Marbello has stood up at the line of scrimmage, maybe a yard. As right now, the Elk trying to minimize the damage after Hamblin, who had the interception on the first defensive series, this time giving the Yellow Jackets great field position after the punt bounces off of his shoulder pad.
Well, another play like that at least gives Blue Ridge the opportunity on third down to run or pass, and I think that's important for them here.
This time handed off to Harris, who is met at the line by Keanu Clark, and he's able to bully his way forward for another yard, maybe two, but makes it third down and probably somewhere in the neighborhood of seven.
Maybe they're saying about six, maybe, five or six. Which is more manageable. Now, what Blue Ridge defenders ball carriers need to be reminded of is hold on the ball. You can see what Round Valley's strategy is, maybe stand up the running back and then go after the strip.
Mitchell standing on London's left. Marbello starting off on the left of the line. Now he moves over to the right side, as does Mitchell, as they're all there to serve as blockers for London, but this time he has to jump over somebody. But a flag comes out. Is I don't know if you're allowed to do that in the amateur ranks. If nothing else, it was a little bit of a demonstration of his athleticism. Is there's a player down, but it looks like he's just getting stretched out for the Elk.
highlight film material. Oh, they're waving it.
So no penalty for hurdling. The ball player was on the ground.
Okay.
Well, now a flag comes out after I think Coach Bell is all the way out at the center of the field.
I think the official did not know that there was an injured player. So they're going to talk about that one. But that would be big because it would be an automatic first down.
Yes, it would. As it stands, it would be fourth down and five.
Here it is.
But unsportsmanlike conduct, Round Valley. It'll be first down, half a distance to the goal line.
That's bad. And again, Round Valley had 75 yards more penalized against them in the first half. And you'd like to think that the officials would not have such thin skin in a circumstance like that when he was just trying to make him aware that one of his men were down.
Yeah, now the problem is Bell was very late.
It was a dead ball foul, so it is fourth down.
So it'll still be fourth down, but fourth down now in three.
Coach Bell was very late to come out, though. His player was down for quite a ways. But I don't know why he didn't just talk to the side judge over there. Why didn't Coach Bell talk to the side judge in order to... Okay, now they're going to have more discussion.
He's coming back out. Does he want a fresh one?
We want to go half the distance again.
So I
don't know why it's not a first down, but I guess it's because it's after the play. The yardage would have to take it to first down, I guess. So they just got half the distance, which doesn't hurt Round Valley a whole lot. It was mainly gives them, 2 yards? Let's see. Let's see if they change their mind. Doesn't look like it. So big fourth down. Now, see, if I'm Blue Ridge right here, I'm kicking the field goal. I'm going to make Round Valley have to score a touchdown to beat me.
Well, they're coming up to the line, bunched up on fourth down and three. Pitch it out to Mitchell, who spins away from one man, but not before three others get him.
That's horrible.
And it's still going to be a one-point ball game after I couldn't see who got there first, but it might have been Clark.
Franco Harris was supposed to be the lead guy out there, and it looks like it was Hamblin on the outside, making up perhaps for the muffed punt.
I think Gage Slade was there first.
It's either Ortiz or Hamblin. And, he just holds up Mitchell enough for everybody else to make the play. But, boy, huge.
Second time we've called Jovan Ortiz's name here on a big play, as he was there for the big third down stop on the previous possession. Now the Elk have it. First and 10 on their own 5. 8 minutes and 58 seconds left in the ballgame. They trail one, and all sorts of flags come out as it looks like they again had too many.
Dead ball, illegal participator, legal substitution, Round Valley. Half the distance.
It's cold. That's a loss of 2.5 yards to make it now first and 12-ish. Very close to the end zone here, and it's chilly. As Young's working from the shotgun.
Wilbank's getting
Wilbank
this ball.
Wilbank is in there. And he gets the call. Starts moving to the right. Accelerates now as he's at the 5. He's at the 10. Tries to cut it back up. And he has a Mountain Mobile Autoglass first down. And perhaps most importantly, valuable real estate separating them from the end zone.
Absolutely. That's a huge thing to get out from the shadow of your own goalpost. And to reestablish the fact that Wilbank can't still run the ball. That was great patience. I mean, he's just a great runner. Round Valley does a good job scheme-wise to get him in a space where he can take advantage of his athleticism. They spread you out.
I got him with 153 yards now on 17 carries. As this time he gets the calls, trying to bounce it out to the left side as he nearly gets that one into space. But Mitchell brings him down before he was able to do any more after that great cut at the line of scrimmage. Gain of 8 on first down, though.
And we've seen... We've seen a lot of different shifts in momentum in this game, and now Round Valley playing with a different level of intensity with their backs up against the wall as they're down one with just the fourth quarter to go, half the fourth quarter.
Second and short there is that time. It was fumbled again after Young held on to that one way too long on the option as Marbello picks it up after it rolls free.
I believe it was Micah Heisler that got back there and hit Wilbank and stripped that ball loose. We'll see it. Yeah, Marbello comes up with the fumble. You can check this out on iTalk 106.7. Snowflake.com. If we can get another quick – oh, we didn't catch the
– I think that Young was trying to hang on to that option read as long as he could, and he just held on to it a little bit too long.
Well, it was definitely Heisler on the bottom of that pile.
So the second fumble here in the second half as there a late pitch after London was almost brought down, and that's going to allow a swarm in the back as Hamblin is there first with Mitchell. Probably fortunate he was able to even get his hands on that.
I know. I mean, you got to call a timeout if you're Blue Ridge and go, hey, we've got to put our bodies in front of somebody because it looks, I mean, it's a flood of white jerseys in the Blue Ridge backfield right now. Round Valley is just doing a great job with penetration, and Blue Ridge has no answer right now.
Marbello and Kern getting split wide to the left. Mitchell in the pistol behind London as they fake the handoff to him, now looking to the far side where there's all sorts of contact, and they're going to whistle Ortiz for an interference flag, but I thought that was incidental.
He had a hold of his jersey. We missed the end of it, but he did have the hold. I caught it just at the end there.
Defensive holding.
Yeah, it wasn't pass interference. It was holding. He just grabbed the jersey as
Kern
was about
down.
to go by. Yeah, the problem was Ortiz was beat. He was coming in hard, and he got beat on the fake and had to hold.
So a 10-yard penalty, and I believe that's an automatic first down.
And as we know, Derek, from being in Round Valley, the fans already give the officials.
Defensive holding against Round Valley. It's second down.
It's not an automatic first down.
They give the officials the business all the time, and so I'm sure they're not happy now.
Second down and one. That somehow is an 11-yard flag as Mitchell gets the call. He only needs one, and he falls over the 20, which should be good enough.
Yep, they just gave it to him.
There's the Mountain Mobile Autoglass first down.
See, COVID. It's COVID math. That's what we're calling it these days.
It has been unfortunate how picked on the Elk have been, but I don't think that is right now the reason that they trail one.
No.
And it's not the two fumbles either. It's just they have not been able to generate anything through the air. Though they have had opportunities. As Kern now is late, moving along the back of the line. He's going to split wide out in single coverage as London drops back. He wants to go in that direction, but he's again blown up. And this time he's able to run up the pocket.
Oh,
he's
going
to get into the end zone for the score. Touchdown.
Wow. I mean, that is a busted play if I ever saw one. London was looking to pass all the time. Now, he had Kern open over the middle, but the pressure was so much in his face. But he was able to just find a hole. And not only that, though, you did see an example there of the strength of London as he did run through a couple of arm tackles.
Now, with this extra point pending, even if it is good, all is not lost for Round Valley because it'd still just be a one possession ball game.
Yeah. Oh, I have a feeling this is going to come down to the wire for sure.
Mitchell is going to come out late and then operate as London's holder.
Does Blue Ridge go for a fake and go for two here? No.
The kick is away and it looks true. No, it's not good. Oh, my good heavens.
Huh.
So it's a 7-point ball game with 6 minutes and 53 seconds left. 13-6, Blue Ridge leads Round Valley. It's Sholo Ford's presentation of high school football at iTalk 106.7 and iTalk1067.com.
Who sells the number one truck in America? Sholo Ford. That's right. Not only do they sell it, Sholo Ford is the best place to buy it.
Like if they stayed right now. But
it's a tough game out there. We can help you reach your goals and come out victorious. Need help paying for college? Let the financial aid experts at Northland Pioneer College help you qualify for federal, institutional, or tribal grants. See our website at npc.edu for details. Northland Pioneer College, expanding minds, transforming lives.
6:53 left, and now it's a 13-6 ball game. As the number 3 Elk have been able to get 160 yards on the ground from Wiltbank, but credit Blue Ridge for just not allowing any of them to be very big. In fact, the largest run was 31 yards, but it was so deep in Round Valley territory, there's nothing they could do with it.
I was going to say the big play has not been there for Round Valley because the passing game has not been there, and that's really where their big play usually comes from, is from the passing game.
Hamblin, who had just dropped a punt
on the penultimate turnover for Round Valley. He's standing on the left, but this one's going down the center and toward Ortiz, who puts both hands on this one at the 10, starts running to his right, runs through one tackler. Now a helmet comes loose as he's in the open field, cuts it back to the 40, and still on his feet as he gets down to the 45 by Hoffmeyer, bringing him down. But that's Franco Harris again losing his hat.
Yeah, it is. Carlos Ruelas also on the tackle, but boy, that's a great spark that Ortiz provides, and he's been the guy a couple times tonight, but that's a great spark that he provides for his team as he gives them great field position because the clock does become a factor here. Oh, and only a 7-point lead, that really changes things.
6:42 left as Young from the shotgun with Wilt Bank on his right. He's got 160 yards at this point as Young's going to keep this one, runs up the right side, dives into some traffic and gets down to the 49, pick up a 4.
Now, Young wasn't looking to pitch that one at all. I'm not sure why, but he was just bound and determined to pick up positive yards, which is not a bad thing. You know, you take 4 yards all night.
4 yards a crack is going to use clock, get into the end zone, and have them with an opportunity to tie or take the lead if they can continue with that production. As there, the handoff is given to Wilt Bank, and he has to slow his pace as he was met at the line of scrimmage, but still falls forward but picks up 3.
Well, the difference that now is Marvello is doing a better job of getting outside contain and forcing Wilt Bank back to his help. Marvello, you know, may not be able to make the tackle one-on-one, but he can certainly get some help. But if he gets beat to the outside, that's where Marvello is going to get, you know, Wilt Bank has the advantage. So good job, good adjustment by the senior linebacker for Blue Ridge. And you know, Round Valley, he's got to start thinking, are they going for one or two if they can get this one in the end zone eventually?
Casey Mortensen is in the backfield as Wilt Banks on the sideline. Young now keeps this one all the way, runs over the 45, he's at the 40, kicks it back to the far sideline where he's down to the 35, and a Mountain Mobile Auto Glass first down.
Wow, that's a huge, huge run, and that's what I was talking about at the beginning of the game, Derek, is his leadership, his willingness to just will his team, put his team on his back, and just carry them to whatever it needs to happen. And that right there, he just does a great job of selling the fake and just running hard downhill, getting north-south, and picking up those big yards.
5 minutes and 20 seconds left, 13-6, Blue Ridge leading. The Elk looking for their first points since their opening drive. Wilt Bank back out there. He's standing on Young's left as they give him the call. Running back to the right side. Again, having to hesitate at the line of scrimmage. And this time, stop for a loss.
Ryan Cox on the tackle for the Blue Ridge Yellow Jackets. And they're actually going to say he lost a yard back close to the 35. But Blue Ridge is doing, like I said, just that contain, not allowing Wilt Bank to bounce to the outside. But this is it. We're getting down to crunch time. I think Round Valley still has all three timeouts left.
Yes. There's second down and 11. Hamblin and Ortiz out here on the left, and now stopping play and
fire the snap. False start, Round Valley.
Who's that on?
I don't know. I think the center might have snapped the ball a little late. Is all I could see because everybody seemed to be in unison, but the ball was delivered a little bit late.
That is now more than 100 penalty yards against Round Valley.
Yeah, cumulatively that might be a difference in this game.
Now they're well behind schedule. Ball back to the 39. Second down and a long 15. Same formation. Receivers on either side of the line as the handoff goes Wilt Bank. This time with a little bit of space, but he's brought down after
not
another
much.
Short gain, 3 yards.
Yeah. Marbello has been a busy young man in the middle of the field. He's a little slow to get up as well, but he'll stay in there. He's a tough kid. No, he is going to come out. So watch for this. Seth Slaughter, the sophomore, going in for him. But this is a big play, and now does Blue Ridge come after Young?
Rowdy Rivera is also back off the sideline for the Elk. As Wilt Bank is again on the left. Young, short drop, wants to pass with time. Looking over the middle where it was behind his intended receiver and incomplete.
That's a bad pass by Young, and after I just gave him so many kudos, he doesn't deliver. I think he thought the window was closing faster than it really was. He really had time, and his receiver had time, and he just couldn't get to him. So I think even with the three timeouts, Round Valley may be thinking this is fourth down territory, but it's going to have to go on Young's arm again. However, something he's got to keep in mind, he might be able to run for this
yes.
if they spread it out enough.
Blue Ridge trying to give an awful lot of space as Young drops back with time. Now see? Pinches up in the pocket, runs it up, but he has two players spying him. Now he's well beyond the line of scrimmage. Hamblin is open in the end zone for the score, and the flag is out now.
Yeah, he was well past the line of scrimmage.
Another flag comes out late as Cisco might have been the victim of a celebration. So this may offset.
Oh, my.
Young was definitely beyond the line of scrimmage.
Let's see if we can get a replay on iTalk on that one. We got a lot to sort out, a lot of laundry to sort. Well, this could be the ball game right here. We only caught the tail end of that replay. There it is. You could see he was in the middle. He was in between the 35 and the 30.
Okay. Got an illegal forward pass, Round Valley. It's a five-yard penalty, and that's loss of down. It's first down, Blue Ridge.
What was the other flag?
Well, they obviously picked up the other flag for some reason. But now for the if you're the Blue Ridge Yellow Jackets, as that ball is, I'm sure, a little moist, it's all about ball security because you're still, you know, fairly deep in your own territory. But, Round Valley's got to try to get a stop right here, use their timeouts on defense, get a stop, three and out, and hopefully have time to make one last drive.
So the scrimmage will be the 37-yard line as London's under center. Men in motion with Marbello going to the far side. Hand this one off to Harris, who is stopped at the 39, gains three.
And you could see right there Owen Young coming after, going after the ball, trying to get a strip on that. The problem is that Round Valley's got to be careful of when you go for the strip, you sometimes give up extra yards. And that if Blue Ridge is able to pick up a first down, I'm very surprised Round Valley is not using its timeouts right now.
Clock under 3 minutes to go as London's taking his time getting into the huddle.
We'll see how well the senior quarterback manages the clock for his team as he's going to watch that back judge.
Split backs behind him as the counting begins as the handoff goes Franco Harris as he has a big surge, gets this one over the 40 to the 43, gain of four, makes it third and short, and I believe that Franco Harris has another one coming his way.
And there's the timeout for Round Valley, but a big block right there by
Round Valley
by Dimitri Muncy.
2:30 to go, 13-6, Blue Ridge leads. It's Sheldon Ford's presentation of high school football on iTalk 106.7 and iTalk1067.com.
Who sells the number one truck in America? Sholo Ford. That's right. Not only do they sell it, Sholo Ford is the best place to buy it. Why? Guy Hatch guarantees it. In fact, he guarantees you'll get the best deal on your next Ford car, van, or SUV as well. It doesn't matter what you buy. Sholo Ford has the best deal. Sholo Ford on the east end of the Deuce and at SholoFord.com.
Oh, yeah. All right, third down and three. With 2 minutes and 30 seconds left, Round Valley really needing a stop. Franco Harris has been the short yardage back as he is going to start on the left of London. No, beg your pardon. Now he moves over to the right. PJ's going under center. As the handoff goes to Harris, who's met at the line of scrimmage but forces his way forward. And it's going to be close, but it doesn't look like he's got it.
Ooh, they may measure. They're going to take it over to that far sideline. They'll bring the chains out. Good job by the side judge, though, not looking back at the chains. He just sets it where he believes it is. And they're going to measure. Yep, good call by Mr. Copeland. He's going to, instead of just calling it, let's go ahead and get an official measurement. So this is a big play. Now Round Valley has two timeouts left, but they got to get a stop at some point. This is a big call.
First down is signaled. Again, Round Valley has been flagged for more than 100 yards. I'm not going to say that that was not a good spot because I plain and simply couldn't see it. What I am saying again to the Elk fans is you have my permission to break something tasteful.
It was in the realm of possibilities for a spot, I would say. Yeah, it wasn't a bad spot, but maybe it might have been a good spot. Who knows?
So first and 10, the clock runs at 2 minutes and 15 seconds left.
I don't know why the clock is running, though. On the first down, the clock should not be running.
Well, they got it spotted.
Oh, yeah, once it's set, that's right.
13-6, the Yellow Jackets have scored all 13 points here in the second half. The Elk have not scored since their opening possession. As London taking a look at the clock, trying to use as much of it as possible.
He's going to watch that back judge, and he's not going to snap it until he sees the count.
And which begins as they hand it off to Harris again with a big surge as he gets toward midfield, and a quick timeout taken by Round Valley.
Hogle on the tackle. And not to be, you know, lost in this, Derek, is Round Valley played well tonight. They played hard. They played well. I'm not, you know, it's not necessarily over, but they have played well, and they definitely dominated the first half. They just couldn't get it in the end zone. In the second half, their offense has stalled out because maybe, as you mentioned, the weather kind of took away some of their passing game, and they had to rely on Wiltbank so much that Blue Ridge was able to key on it. And when you go that one-dimensional, you know, that's the price you pay. And as you mentioned, Blue Ridge went one-dimensional also, but they've been able to execute it better.
Well, I think the bigger revelation here has been the running from Franco Harris.
Yeah, short yardage. I mean, he is definitely your short yardage guy. He has the weight, the power, and the strength to pick up 2 or 3 yards.
1 minute and 42 seconds as they put a few ticks back on the clock. Round Valley now with just one timeout.
And I'm sure they'll take it after this play.
Snap is had, this time give to Mitchell, who's got a little bit of space as he goes hard over the 45 and is close to another Mountain Mobile Auto Glass first down. And They're moving the chains, and that will do it.
Yeah, that's the worst thing that could happen right there for Round Valley, because now the timeout is basically moot. Blue Ridge can take a couple knees and call it good. Even if Round Valley does use their last timeout, which they may elect not to.
It doesn't look like it's going to happen, so we can let the speculation begin. I've already seen that Snowflake had last we saw a 20-0 lead over Payson, all likelihood going to remain at the number two spot. Round Valley will now descend from its three. My concern, just as being a fan of 3A East football, is that what you're probably going to wind up with is some combination, as Blue Ridge uses at one of its final timeouts. The Elk and the Yellow Jackets are probably going to be now in the 4-5 spot, which would mean that they would wind up having to play Yuma Catholic before the championship game.
Well, they're going to play each other.
Yes.
First in the quarterfinals, which, you know, that stinks for both these teams because, I know I'm definitely biased, but these are two of the best teams in the state. These are probably two of the top five teams in the state. And for them to have to meet that early is kind of tough.
I had mentioned at halftime when you were away. I'm not saying that bitterly, but they right now, as it had stood, the all three teams from the 3A East were looking as if they wouldn't have to play Yuma Catholic, which is again a full 5 power points ahead of everybody.
Yeah, they're going to hold on to the one spot because they're playing some cupcake. I don't know.
Well, but they got a tradition. They got a history. As there's the victory formation from the Yellow Jackets, Round Valley is looking like it's still not having much of it, but there's not a lot the Elk can do.
But the timeout.
Round Valley.
Take that last timeout. They shall, though.
You know, and if you look at the PowerPoints, you know, separating, you know, Snowflake, I think, has a stranglehold on number two. No one's going to leapfrog them there. But between 2 and 7 is a point and a half. Actually, 2 and 8 is a point and a half difference. Everybody, and those are all teams with one loss. And so it's really going to be interesting to see how it does shake out. Obviously, Round Valley has 2 losses. We'll see how far they drop, because I'm pretty sure Valley Christian will beat Sholo tonight. American Leadership, Gilbert North should win. And so they may get leapfrogged, and we might see them drop as far as 6.
And that's if I'm Round Valley, I'm saying let's go.
Yeah, yeah.
I know most coaches are going to tell you, look, you're going to have to play Yuma Catholic eventually, so might as well go ahead and do it. But, I mean, I would much rather do that as late in the tournament as possible. Again, not trying to heap too much praise on the guys, but, again, they got a history.
As Blue Ridge should, you know, depending on how they do things, they might have to, they might just snap it one more time. Yep, now they're within time.
Round Valley trying to...
I don't know what Round Valley's doing.
They're trying to force a fumble. So a three-way tie.
That's the last thing. Well, actually, Snowflake's probably glad about that because they were on the outside looking in.
Round Valley frustrated, and again, we've been mentioning it. Got to give all sorts of credit to the Yellow Jackets. They're playing under the same circumstances, but the Elk are foregoing a handshake.
Well, it's COVID times. There's no handshake.
Well, the polite single file line.
Right.
I'd be interested to know what inspired that.
Well, I'm sure they're not too excited about the officiating. But well, as you mentioned, Derek, the calls didn't seem to really affect the game a whole lot.
There's some chatter between a couple of the Round Valley coaches and the officials as they're all walking off. But it again, the biggest deciding factor in this one was not the abundance of yards flagged against Round Valley. Neither was it the two fumbles late. It was just the elements forbade Round Valley from getting an air attack going.
Yeah, what they wanted to do offensively tonight was not there tonight. And part of that was Blue Ridge taking it away, and part of that was the weather. But that's something they got to overcome.
13-6 is the final. We'll start wrapping it up after this. It's the Sholo Ford presentation of high school football on iTalk 106.7 and iTalk1067.com.
Are you going?
All right, you're clear. How long do you want?
Let's just do a minute. I gotta get out of this cold.
Gotta get out.
You've been there, waiting forever at the gas station for the guy to free up so he can fill up your propane tank. Or worse, when the only qualified propane technician decided to stay home that day. Yep, you've been there and I have too. That's why now I get my propane from Ace Hardware every time. You get Ace Hardware's world-famous customer service when you stop in for propane. That's right, you get in, you get out, and you get a great deal on propane and everything else. From Ace Hardware at their locations in Pine Top and Heber. Ace Hardware is proud to support White Mountain Sports.
When you think glass, think Deemer's Glass in Lakeside. Deemer's Glass offers the best selection of quality glass with affordable prices. They do full home window packages, replacement windows, custom shower doors and enclosures, custom mirrors in many shapes, styles, and colors, glass doors and hardware, commercial glass for buildings and offices, skylights, screens, fire-rated glass for your fireplace or stove, window film, and more. Visit Deemer's Glass today on Porter Mountain Road in Lakeside or call 1-888-GLASSMAN.
Final was 13-6. Now a three-way tie sets up as Round Valley had beaten Snowflake. Snowflake had beaten Blue Ridge. Blue Ridge had beaten Round Valley. I'm not sure how they're going to try to sort that out. I think they ought to just let them each hang it up.
They will. They will have a three-way tie. Everybody gets to claim the regional title. And what else it does, as I said, is it gives all three teams an automatic berth into the playoffs. So that's good.
Well, they're also loftily had with the PowerPoints. Is there the play of the game, the Deemers, Beeler Orthodontics, straight line play of the game, Beeler Orthodontics, live to smile, love your smile. That was on 3rd and 9 and wound up getting a big gainer to Reese Esparza, which was really the extent of the passing game for Blue Ridge. Yeah. And it came at a perfect opportunity as Esparza was able to get his hands on that one and run that out to the 11-yard line. So that is our straight-line Beeler Orthodontics play of the game. Live to smile, love your smile. As we shift gears now to the Deemer's Glass, glass-shattering hit of the game. Hey, need glass for your home or business? Deemer's Glass in Lakeside is hands down the best place to call. Quality glass at affordable prices. Deemer's Glass, call 1-888-GLASSMAN. And we're looking at here as quarterback to quarterback, Owen Young gets hit hard by P.J. London. As that was going to be something that was going to be a bit of a theme, as again, got to highlight how Seth Wiltbank had, according to my count, 165 yards, and you talked about how much of those were stops from London once he got to the second level. But Blue Ridge playing the bend but don't break defense on the ground, and a lot of that is going to, I'm going to give myself a little bit of credit, highlighting how they were able to play the field position game expertly in the first half when it looked as if Round Valley was having all sorts of momentum. But you know, they were starting so deep, it didn't matter.
Yeah, you know, Blue Ridge kind of got popped in the mouth a little bit, but it took them a while, but they did kind of clear the cobwebs, especially defensively. And as you said, they really kept Round Valley in check for the most part in that first half, and then that continued and got even better. I think
Round Valley probably having fewer yards in the second half. So credit the coaching staff of the Blue Ridge Yellow Jackets. And, you know, Coach Bell will learn from this and try to have a little more flexible plan coming into it when the weather conditions are what they
and
are.
And that's the thing, again, because there is some egregious fumbles in the second half. That did not have the biggest impact. I mean, you're going to look at that and say of the fumble, particularly Leland Hamblin had the punt bounce off his shoulder pad. That was a bad one. But had Round Valley, and again, Blue Ridge had to play in these same circumstances, but the Round Valley not being able to generate anything from the air was really the biggest factor. So if you're looking for a finger to point, I think you got to go right to Mother Nature, because this is the first ball game of the year where it was very cold. Of course, Round Valley never really has to play half of its ball games in any sort of element. So the question coming into it was exactly how are they going to deal? And the answer to that one was, unfortunately,
not
poorly.
Not great. I mean, they I wouldn't go as far as say poorly, but certainly
well, just
not,
from the passing attack.
Yeah, definitely. Not what they were accustomed to. Young just didn't have it tonight.
So the final score goes 13-6. If the football gods are going to smile upon us, I would like to go ahead and speculate that this was not the only time these two teams are going to play each other.
Yeah, it's very possible these two teams end up 4-5. I'd like to have our 3A East team spread out a little bit more.
Yeah.
I'd like to see maybe Blue Ridge move to 3 and Round Valley to 6 so they wouldn't necessarily face each other, and we might have some more teams from the East in the semifinals.
That's all we got. We've got the playoffs starting for you after this. Thanks for listening and starting your weekend with us. I'm Derek Palmer from Mike Grunillo and Ashley in the studio and everybody in the truck. This has been Sholo Ford's presentation of high school football on iTalk 106.7 and iTalk1067.com.
This has been Sholo Ford's presentation of high school football on iTalk 106.7 KNKI Pine Top and iTalk1067.com. Brought to you in part by Northland Pioneer College, Ace Hardware of the White Mountains, Deemer's Glass, Beeler Orthodontics, Summit Regional Medical Center, Octopus Car Wash, Mountain Mobile Auto Glass, and Little Blue Bird Studios. This broadcast has been a copyrighted production of iTalk 106.7 and Country Mountain Airwaves, a Kopaniki communications station. Any rebroadcast, retransmission, or use of this broadcast without the expressed written consent of iTalk 106.7 or Country Mountain Airwaves is strictly prohibited. For more information on this game and other games around the region, go to iTalk1067.com.